Today's A Mediocre Time with Tom and Dan is brought to you by
Streamline Mortgage Solutions. I like to look at Brian as basically my personal mortgage consultant.
Yeah.
And you can do that too.
He is
cuckoo bananas for low interest rates.
Well, the rates are insanely low right now. Give them a call. You could just go over everything on the phone, and they'll let you know, with some stuff they need to see.
Well, don't be intimidated by it. It's one of the easiest things you're going to do, and let me just read from somebody who did it. All right? I got a guy right here that did it. I got it. Little piece of paper. It says refinance. I use Streamline Mortgage Solutions based on the recommendation of my favorite podcast, Tom and Dave. I have reached out to Brian a number of times over the last year, and he was almost very honest with me. What? And he was. That's what it actually says. Do you want me to read that?
It says he was almost very honest.
Yeah, it does say that actually. Should we start this over? Read that. It says he was almost very honest with me.
That's our listener.
Why the fuck would you write that?
Because he's like me. Guess what? Like, our listeners, either you or me.
I see what he was saying. He would tell me if it was the right time to refinance. You know what? We're starting over. Or should we leave it? I don't know what to do anymore.
Leave it. This is the best conference you've ever heard.
Sit back in your fucking cars, listen to these ads, and you judge it. I know what you're doing. You're gripping that steering wheel, and you're like, oh, the little one. He stopped in the middle. He broke the fourth wall. He stepped through it, and he said, hey, Tom. You know what? Fuck it. It stays.
Listen.
God damn it.
This is the thing. Interest rates are insanely low. Ask him about refinance.
Bullshit. Just do it.
Quit paying insanely high interest rates in other aspects of your life, like credit cards and stuff. You're paying all this insane. Just go and consolidate everything.
Yeah.
Take money out of your house. Home prices are insanely high right now. You're definitely
be almost honest with yourself, you
just
idiot.
Do what's good at business and use Streamline Mortgage. Call Brian Zimel, his team. They'll help you out. Like I said, everything over the phone. If you're buying a house, use them for the mortgage.
Hold on a second.
Barton Crystal use Streamline exclusively because they're so good and they get things done.
I'm having a second thoughts. I'm going to stop.
I said exclusively.
Yeah, I know you did. I wanted to make fun of you, but I was like, you know, we're just going to stop it. I'm second guessing everything now.
Yeah.
Is Sam back? Where's Sam?
I don't know.
God.
This wouldn't happen
if Sam was here.
She's the problem.
You know what? Fuck Sam.
We were doing good.
It's her fault.
StreamlineFlorida.com.
Live from the Streamline Mortgage Solutions Studio, it's Orlando's own Tom and Dan.
Whoopee!
Hello. This is your Mediocre Time with Tom and Dan program. We hope that you will find our presentation precise, joke-heavy, and just right. Thanks.
Welcome to the Friday free show of A Mediocre Time.
Hey, hey, hey! Welcome to the Friday free show of A Mediocre Time with Tom and Dan. I am Daniel.
I'm Thomas.
Samantha Ann is here as well. Hello, Samantha Ann. Oh my God, I can't hear you. Hold on, I had you potted down.
You had me gone. Turned my mic off.
Well, just because you're not virtual doesn't mean that I still have to treat you like a woman.
Gotcha.
I think we forget to turn your mic on about
all the time.
That's my fault.
Back to normal. Yeah, that's right.
Now you can look in the corner and I'm here.
Yeah, it's all back to normal. Everything's right now.
Travi Paul Randy is here as well. Yeah.
Hello there.
There he is. British Travi is here as well. Welcome to the program. Show number 606 of A Mediocre Time. It's weird that we've done 606 shows. I guess the next big milestone will be the 666 show.
What do we do then?
I think we do that show from Babyland General.
Yes.
In Georgia, we go to Xavier Roberts Babyland General Hospital, and we purchase Tom Van One Cabbage Patch doll, and we have the nurse from Babyland General come out, present it to you, and that's the day that we decide to stop the show. Tom and I have been kicking that idea around.
Okay.
No, seriously.
I need a backup plan.
No, not the business.
Hold on. Just slow down. Just everybody chill out. We
contemplated like stopping a mediocre time with Tom, like having an end date, like
that's it.
1,000 shows.
Yes.
That's it. And for this particular show, there'll be another show.
Yeah, we'll reinvent the whole damn thing.
But,
but seriously, we thought about this. Should I not be talking about this?
That doesn't matter.
So when you guys leave on Friday afternoons, it's the Tom and I are so relieved to have the office to ourselves.
Yeah.
First thing we do is we hug each other and then we talk about how much we missed each other. Yeah. And then we go through a series of fantasies, one of them being that after 1,000 shows, we will kill it. That is it. The show is dead. The branding's dead. The logo, everything is fucking gone. It's dead.
Okay. Mm-hmm. And then do you get new names and personalities? Or
we don't know.
No. Yet. Yeah,
okay.
We haven't figured that part out. We got some
work
time.
In progress.
Yeah,
okay.
Yeah. But we, I feel like every show should have like a plan for an ending. When they don't have a plan, I think that's when they fuck it up, right?
You gotta have a plan.
Because, like, if you look at
you don't want to burn out.
Is The Walking Dead still going on?
Yes.
Oh, my God.
Yeah.
Oh, my God.
Is
it still happening?
Some iteration of it is going on. It's not the Rick Grimes story anymore. I think it's something else.
Oh, my God.
Well, who took over?
It's Fear the Walking
Dead.
The
gray-haired lady.
There's another version of it as well.
Well, that's a totally different...
The gray-haired lady that everybody thought was a lesbian but wasn't.
Oh, yeah. Old young lady.
Old young. She's hot.
I don't know.
Carol. Hot-ass old Carol.
What about Samurai? Michonne or whatever.
She's still alive.
Okay. But some of the... Yeah. Anyway.
I got to tell...
How is it still... Anyway.
If
it should have been a finite ending to that.
Had I been a betting man, I would not have bet on young old lady and Black Samurai. Samurai, because I mean,
it's
beautiful
cool.
and
yeah.
athletic, but
so there's, mm-hmm. yeah, there's been 10 seasons. They're still going.
Oh my God! Yeah.
Pack it in.
Announce when the ending's coming, because that's the only saving grace.
You know what I would like for them to do if I were one of their writers? I'm serious, because like, let's think about actual TV and what's popular right now. This WandaVision thing's out of control. People talk about it.
What is that?
They love it. They hate it. They love it.
Some kind of nerd Marvel thing.
Follow me with this.
DC? I don't know.
Walking Dead. Rick Grimes is dead. Right? You know, like, I think that's not a spoiler. I think that's, you know, we all knew that was going to happen.
Didn't he fly away or something?
Get a vaccine. Fix the world. And then make the whole show zombie free for the new versions of it. And just make, you know, Carl's going to work. It's a normal day.
His
wife's cheating on him. Make that the storyline. Now that's, you're flipping me on my ear. That's creative.
There's a vaccine to turn the zombies back to humans?
Yeah, they're all back. Everything's fixed now. It's just, This Is Us.
Does your flesh come back? Stay looking gross?
You're like, oh my God, my mouth!
No, your flesh all comes back.
Okay.
Yeah,
that's a harder vaccine. That's something bigger than Johnson & Johnson.
Bigger than Johnson.
By the way, your company sounds like two giant dicks.
I never thought of that. I'm so stupid. What are we doing? We got to normally get announcements out of the way.
Two things. One, we got new hats. Daniel's wearing it. And it's our...
Hey, Sam.
What are you calling this
Can you run
guy?
And grab Sam's real fast?
I would call it...
Hold that up. So I want people to know that this is a bent brim hat.
Florida / tribute to Evel Knievel.
It's a great
new brand. I don't know. It's a camo. It's on TomandDan.com
right
now.
An American 159 on the side. This is again a dome hat, but
this is our Trump hat.
For those of you that have said before that we don't do the nice curved hat, we do. I just happen to run mine flat because I wear glasses. But this comes up every single hat we ever produce. There's usually like some sort of hat gate battle in the comments. I'm just want to insist that you guys know that this thing is pre-bent and it fits perfectly right out of the box.
And for sure they'll sell out because we sold more. Eric texts me more hats in one day than we ever have. I ordered double the normal.
It's a comfy hat.
But
you guys better start buying them.
It will sell out. No, I think half of them are already gone. And then...
That's not good because we bought hundreds.
We're also running a special where if you buy this hat and there's like five different select shirts that you can get 20% off if you combo them together. So that's on TomandDan.com as well. And I want to mention I found this new product thanks to Dan that Trulieve has. That is
Dan Winkler from Orlando Weekly.
No, you, Dan Dennis. You told me about.
Don't ever call me that.
I call them the white pills, but they're
That's a song by Samantha Ann.
They're Trulieve CBN pills.
Oh, you're being serious? Yeah, CBN, dude.
And dude, like I have a problem falling asleep, and
same.
I take a bunch of melatonin, and then I started dabbling in the old. Zanny, but no, I'm joking.
I was reading the comments and just kind of doing producing things over here, and I was like, my God, we should be worried.
You know those pills you buy over the counter that
extends.
No, I got it. By the way, that does not work. Jimmy Johnson, fuck you. Why did
Jimmy
you do
Johnson,
it?
Johnson and Johnson, all
why?
The Johnson.
Who's your manager? Who's your agent that said, hey, Jimmy Johnson, if you're an old man, used to be
they
respected.
Must have given him a sweet deal, right?
But how, like, he could endorse. But he, like,
because he could endorse Cialis or, you know, Viagra.
It's a bull. Yeah,
why extend?
It's to make your boner, but give me a break. Anyway.
You guys got to try that out and let me know how it is.
It doesn't work.
No, of course it doesn't. But
I mean, I'll try it out. I take any pill anybody gives me.
So,
I have a
what
pill.
What if I take it?
I have a pill in my pocket that I honestly don't know what it is, and I'm going to take it after the show.
All right. Surprise pill. Yeah.
So, if you check out the CBN pills, they're white Trulieve pills.
Yeah.
They're not like, you know, the regular ones.
I mean, just ask for CBN. They'll know.
And from what I understand, just to let you guys know, I believe they're 5 milligram. I call it big boy melatonin. Melatonin doesn't work for me. Melatonin, when I take it, and my wife's dabbled in it, I've tried it. I suffer from bouts of, obviously, anxiety, depression, insomnia. But these, if I pair it with a little bit of THC, it eases me into... I start yawning like crazy. I don't know if you do that.
Then
you're out. And it is a nice... gentle sleep. You don't feel high. There are no psychoactive effects at all. It does more like what you perceive the melatonin should do. But it's like, CBN. It's anti-inflammatory too, which I've been using for my arthritis.
Do you feel like not groggy the next day?
No, not at all.
It's
you can't really tell you took anything. It just makes you yawn a lot.
Remember the first time you ever took melatonin and it worked?
No, I've never taken it.
Oh, okay. Yeah. Yeah. But that's what it's like.
I kind of agree with you. It's like taking NyQuil for the first time.
The shit stopped working for me. This dude was stupid melatonin. And then I started taking more and more. And then I'm like, how much of this shit can I actually take? It's like, it doesn't even do anything. And then this is like, boom, puts me. And it's a great product. And I know by mentioning it, my good friend Fake Norm told me that Longwood Trulieve still has some on a run out.
Well, now they're going to sell out.
Yeah, they're hard to find. But there you go. There's a public service announcement.
Also, when you buy it, just send us a text of a picture. Obviously, fill out the form if you want the Trulieve camo hat and the gift bag.
But attach a picture. Please attach a picture.
Yeah, I mean, but if you don't want to fill out the form, you don't care about it, just send us the picture because that helps our Trulieve relationship and helps track results for us.
Just keeps us accountable to our clients, you know.
So
we're one of those weird media outlets that likes to be accountable for what we do when you give us money.
Mm-hmm.
Imagine that.
So,
you want to do voicemails, emails?
Yeah. Let's just.
Let's do
so
a little.
Voicemails.
Well, I was gonna say we do mail on mail because, like, honestly, we've neglected it. Sam's here, high energy. I'm happy to have her back. Boys are back in town. You know, let's do it. Let's do mail on mail. Here we go.
Hey guys, thanks for calling 1-800-HOT-DICK, the place to find real action with real men. To make it even better, we've got new low prices. So low, we're practically giving it away free.
If you are a man seeking a woman, press 1. If you are a woman seeking a man, press 2. If you are a man seeking a man, press 3.
Mail. On mail.
Mail on mail, bot. God damn it.
Marilyn Mail, Baba Daba Doo, Baba Dee Baba Doo.
Brought to you by our BDM subscription service, which this is an embarrassing true story. I was looking at the wrong number for the entire
time. God damn it.
The entire
we're going all honesty today.
Of our company. And then I was like, all right, this is, a, you know, like, this is the number
we have. A number for years, it seems like.
Travis writing the damn number down. And then one morning I get in here, and I'm like, what is it? Like, looking at a subscription, like a third party, Stripe does it. Like, obviously,
right. yeah.
They take your credit card. We have nothing to do with that. We don't know anything. You know, you
we
sign up.
We do not touch your credit card numbers.
We have to pay this service that handles
subscriptions. They wouldn't trust us with that. We can't even count the members.
And then I go, and then I'm like, oh, well, there's a section here where you can filter by active.
Right.
And then instead of paid, which I was doing another thing, and then I go to that,
man.
I was like, go, it's a different number. And then I was like, oh, there's a lot of people that have let their damn membership lapse, and it was still counting in the other number. And then I started going back
it's
there.
It's always a good sign when he yells from the other room. He'll be like, oh. Hold on a second. Is it active members? And I'm like, well, I mean, what else would it be? And then I hear, okay, I'm all made up.
That must mean the numbers have dropped.
You know, we're not gonna. And then he'll say something like this. Hey, you know what? I've been thinking. We're not going to record before lunch today. I need to straighten some things out. The door will slowly shut.
Anyway, just check if your BDM status is active, because it may not be, and we may not have caught it. And we sent some emails. Butler's been doing that. Anyway, listen, we're honest. And I think if other companies were honest about their true business dealings, and I mean, you would be shocked, because I know I can't be the only buffoon in town. I've seen them all. I look at every one of them in the eyes, and I'm like, way you're that much better than me.
You are not.
You can't be. I see what you do.
I agree.
I look at all the corporate, I believe, all the fucking corporate people we used to work with. I look at all the higher-ups. I'm buffoon. No way. No way. I mean, at least equal buffoon. There's no way they're that much better.
I think I found the name after 1,000 shows. It's just going to be called Buffoon. Buffoon. God, you spilled your drink
what
everywhere.
What the hell just happened?
Sorry. Why did you dump your drink everywhere?
I have no ice to, anyway.
The ice holds the drink in. That's how cups work, guys.
Yeah.
What the fuck is happening?
We gotta get Tom a sippy cup. Now he's dropping his phone on the floor.
First email.
The Mountain Dew should fix the phone.
Crash the phone with Mountain Dew seeping into the screen.
It's an older email, but, you know, we don't get to them often,
you took off for 2 weeks.
I know.
What are we supposed to do?
Happy New Year to you and the family. I wish you the best. I hope you care, nature you inherited, maintain the glow I recognize, despite the sadness you hold. I miss seeing you and stuff live. I really want to call and explore my sexual stuff with Tom. I, however, am fast asleep when you start BDM shows. But my main reason to hit y'all up is you no longer have the Bernie guy as financial ad, which that's not true.
Yeah, we do.
I looked on the hookups and could not find them. I always wondered, with your exclamations of Bernie's size, if he was a bear of a man and what he looked like.
Yeah, he's a bear of a man.
Oh, yeah.
But I would also wonder if he could point me in the direction of somewhere in LA local so I can be better set up for when another pandemic hits. I shall not be helped as I was this year, so if you no longer are working with him, that's cool, but I figured I'd give you a holler either way.
No.
Ron, the big queer guy.
Oh! Ron!
You could do it over the phone. You don't. I mean, this is 2021. You don't need to do anything in person anymore.
You can email him everything.
Well, I think he just, like, wanted to see what Bernie looked like to see what
Ron's
Bernie looked like.
Horny big black gay man.
There may be a picture of Bernie on OrlandoCPA.net.
Okay, Bernie's body type I would describe as 1950s Superman.
Yes, barrel chest.
He's a big man, he's a big bear man. Yeah,
if
he were gay, he would be coveted.
His hands, his fingers are...
He can cover your entire face with his hands.
Oh, man.
There are many sausages.
I think there's a video of Bernie here.
I think in the gay community, if he were gay, he is not. I don't believe he's happily married.
Right.
Yes. To a woman. Well, you can be happily married and gay. But I'm just saying, you know what I'm saying. He's not into that. But if he were, he would be hurting things.
We're going to have him on next week.
He'll break you back.
That guy.
There's a lot of different tax shit from 2020 that you should just ask Bernie about. He's been our accountant for years and years now, and his team is great. Yeah. And they just handle it all. Like,
we're going to have him in.
If you own a small business,
next
you don't.
Next Tuesday, I think.
Yeah.
Yeah.
See you next Tuesday. We'll have him in, and he'll discuss how we're going to do our taxes now that we live in a completely socialist society. Let's go with this one right here.
Hey guys, it's Sam. Just want to say I love the show lately. I do have to agree with Tom on this. Nothing I do would convince my wife to give me a blowjob. That would...
What?
The world could be ending and she might allow another female to do it and she will not.
Wow. Like, I know that some people don't like doing that, but that is a hatred. My God.
That just came in. That's like breaking news. That's the...
I think there's a good amount of women that do not like doing that. They're the opposite Khaled.
I think my wife would just underhand me an auto blow.
Wait a minute. Let's do anything but that.
But let's
Could it be the TMJ for your wife, though?
I didn't say it was my wife. Well, how dare you?
This guy was saying he agreed with you.
She's a
your blow wife...
machine.
Wow.
Never. I can't even get out of the house every morning.
My God.
I'm like, please, I have to swat her away like gnats.
Jeez, Louise. I'm shitting now. Please take your mouth off my cock.
Yeah, it could be that. You know, there's a lot of factors involved. Me, my personality.
Mike B, commenting on you saying your wife was, quote, a blow machine, says, fucking Christ. That's what Mike B says. Which is, if you had to guess, Tom Van, across North America, let's throw Canada in there, do more women hate blowjobs or do more men hate cunnilingus?
I think just because
you could probably find that
of stereotype.
How do you quantify that, though?
There's different cultures that you
also,
know what I'm saying.
I think it's not quite the same as hating, but I think more women give blowjobs than men give fellatio.
Although men are more horny, so
a lot of guys refuse to do it.
Do gay guys get more blowjobs than straight guys? I have a ton of blowjob questions, guys.
100%.
I got a whole book of them.
Guys are just more
gay
horny.
Gay guys get more blowjobs for sure.
Damn it.
But yeah, and I will say,
man, if I were gay,
a blowjob is easier. I agree with you. I'm gonna die on that hill. I've said it for years.
I used to not agree with you. I agree with you now, and I'll go one step further. If it were possible, it's not because I'm not. But man, there is a part of me that it sounds really nice to live at my mom's beach house and be gay and just get blowjobs all the time with my cool gay lover. Oh man, that sounds like a good life. Rich as fuck, surfing all day long.
Yeah.
It just blowjobs.
To me,
beaches and blowjobs.
Is there anything better?
That's great.
It's the difference between a super complicated controller and just, one joystick. Like,
I have never wanted to fist bump you more. It's the old Nintendo controller. Two buttons,
because
A and B, buddy.
On one hand,
A and B.
You're trying to look for something.
Don't give me the left bumper. Don't give me the right bumper. You got a left trigger. Left triggers and bumpers.
It's very accurate. There's a bullseye involved.
I need the
blowjob.
What happened to the D-pad? The D-pad's gone. What are these swirly things?
It's like you can almost do anything down there. I'll like anything. And people complain about teeth, but I'll take some teeth. That's a small price to pay.
I mean, what? If it's nothing or teeth, I go teeth all day. Right?
Yeah, yeah. It's not that bad.
I just block it out.
My penis isn't that sensitive. Also,
it's also not that big. There's not a lot of work with down there. It's not like she's biting it in half. It's not like a summer sausage from
It's seen.
I don't even know who makes those anymore.
Johnsonville
sausage out of a dog's mouth. Yeah,
yeah. It's not.
And I also feel like a regular man's penis. Now Daniel may not because he's because
I'm a midget
uncircumcised. Oh. No, and yours may be more sensitive.
Uncut.
But I feel like a circumcised man's penis is way tougher. Like, especially
than an uncircumcised
old...
man?
No, yeah. More sensitive, right?
Yeah, we're like Butler and I have veal.
Yeah.
Wings.
That's what I'm saying. Then I'm saying a circumcised penis is tougher.
Yeah.
It is. And then from the years of abuse, the lost sensitivity and things, you know, like
it's like a circumcised.
So little teeth isn't going to.
You can hit it as hard as you want almost.
A circumcised penis is like Billy Joe Armstrong's light blue punk rock guitar that he plays at every show.
Okay.
And me and Butler's penises are like like brand new Guitar Center guitars that are hanging on the wall.
Yeah, yeah.
That's a perfect analogy. Yeah.
Mine's got mud all over it from Woodstock.
Yeah, Durst. Fred Durst is throwing clumps of mud at you, and you're surfing on plywood.
Let's do another email.
Mm-hmm. All right. I was listening to an ACT Best Of. Those are great, by the way. Thanks so much for putting them together. And heard Tom talking about his confusion with Minecraft. A streamer called Sips on Twitch, YouTube, and Twitter recently started a DadCraft server for prominent streamers who have kids. It looks like the content creators taking part are gaining a lot of viewers from each other. I have no contact with these folks, but I wanted to share just in case there was a potential for an interview with one of the DadCrafters or even getting T&D on the server.
I reached out. Yeah, I reached out. I'm going to try and conquer this for Tom because there's no way that somebody that loves his sons as much as I know he does should hate Minecraft this much. We have to get over that hurdle.
Well, because that's because his kids don't know how to play and they just build suicide towers.
But that's what they're supposed to be doing.
They put ladders on them now.
Right.
But all right. We'll step out now.
No, but do you understand? He hates
more
this.
Efficient.
But they are doing what they're supposed to be doing. They're using their imaginations. As strange as they may be, right. They are using their imaginations.
It might be a call for help. We might need to step in.
What, their suicide towers?
Yeah. Well, now they don't. They can climb up on the ladder stand and now it's more of a observation, and they climb back down the ladder to jump to their death.
I love these toys. They're so cool.
Also, I did figure out something that they enjoyed doing, which was teaching me, and this happened like 2 days ago, where Tom or Max finishes his homework first because his kindergarten homework is easy to Max.
Breeze, yeah.
And then so he gets to play Minecraft first and then by himself. Then Tommy gets 15 minutes by himself once he finishes. Anyway, so Tommy's 15 minutes, he wanted to teach Daddy how to play Minecraft.
Okay.
Usually they're both playing, so there's no room for old man. But this time, they set up an account for
Could
me.
Could you tell that hurts his feelings?
Yeah.
They set up a dad account, and then I started playing. And then they were teaching me, but they got very frustrated quick.
Oh,
because I was
turnabout play.
They're like jump, jump! It's like you gotta. There's like there's
you don't
the
know
cold.
How to commit suicide, the tower. You fucking idiot!
And then I dug myself down to the center of the earth and started mining a gigantic cavern underneath. They're like,
this
no,
guy doesn't know how to suicide.
And they're like, you need a goddamn axe to get the gold, like a metal axe, and you have a regular coal axe. And then I'm like, shit! And then Max finally took my controller, and then they just started playing it.
I hope he swiped it. I hope he didn't just grab it. I hope he was like a, you know, like a snatch.
And then
I
like,
want a snatch.
They're like, it's night. Go to bed. The goblins are coming or whatever. And I'm like, what? And then I'm like, what is that spider about trying to whack it with the axe?
Oh, rookie move.
Anyway.
There you go.
It's stupid. But yeah. I do enjoy that they, you know, they
so
want
you're coming
to teach
around
me.
A little bit. Are you going to do some Minecraft this weekend?
If they want to teach me only, okay. I hate it every second of it. It's not entertaining to me. I'm like, what is this? What am I supposed to do? And then they're like, crafting tables. I'm out of
it. Oh my God, that's great. Let's try. Well, this is a series of three drunk voicemails. I look at this less as a collection of voicemails, more as almost like an art installation. This is from Carl. I know we haven't visited him in a while. I'm kind of worried about this guy. The weird thing about this one, though, is that Carl takes on the persona of another caller, Southern Kermit.
Hey, Tom, it's me, Southern Kermit. I'm just at
he's at a bowling alley. Good job. Well, you are a pro.
Playing bowling lane, and I just wanted to say, I bowled 279.
He is
okay. Carl.
Yeah. When does it end, though? Because it continues here.
It'll end.
Hey guys, this is me. I'm just doing a call. I'm just gonna say,
if every time you drink, you lose the ability to communicate entirely.
Who is not there yelling at you? I don't know.
Raise your crow.
Yeah.
Raise
your crow or your daughter filming
raise
you.
Raise your crow.
Like David Hasselhoff.
Your daughter filming you eat a cheeseburger. You're like, where's
the shame?
Someone's got a shame, Carl.
Someone in your life is not yelling at you or shaming you.
Shame you into getting your shit together.
Yeah.
But the sad fact is, if you have no one to shame you, that means no one loves you.
Ooh, that brought it down.
Yeah, it did. But I'm just being honest. I mean, the shame comes from a place of goodness, right?
Yeah, yeah, yeah. That's why we encourage it, because we don't care either way. But, you know, I mean, all we want is the horrible voicemails.
There's a part three.
We can make fun of.
Oh, it's a karaoke night now. All
right. By the way, Carl, how are you that drunk getting from one place to the other? If I'm ever that drunk, I'm only...
I think he's in one spot.
And what do you think he's blasted? Runaway Train.
Hey, Tom Down, Butlers.
Sam,
I had a really good question. Growing up, having malto meal and having cream of wheat...
Which of these
tastes better?
Multi-meal or cream of wheat?
I don't know what multi-meal is.
Multi-meal.
I think it's like another one of those packaged breakfast type of...
I've never had any of those.
Oatmeal?
I've had cream of wheat. Kind of gross.
I have not.
I like Weetabix until it gets soggy. That's my
That's
jam.
A British one, right? Oh, yeah. Yeah.
I've never eaten oatmeal in my entire life.
Oh, I love
it. I mean,
oatmeal.
I've had oatmeal, but just like the Quaker Oats bullshit.
You know what? I strike that. It's in my smoothie that I've been eating every morning
every
for two
fucking
and a half
day.
Years.
Oatmeal in your smoothie?
Yeah, they put that in there.
Gross.
Yeah.
I think we found
lots of sugar.
I think we know why the beans are quite sweet this time of year.
You got maple and brown sugar oatmeal in your goddamn smoothies?
Motherfucker, I got an oatmeal raisin cookie smoothie.
Like 43 grams of sugar.
Next email.
Pandemic shenanigans. I wonder how the pandemic and the work from home trend has impacted teenage antics. I know some teenagers who would skip school and then go back to their house and play video games or smoke pot or invite people over, knowing that their parents would be gone to work until 5 or 6 at night. For a lot of kids, that is no longer a thing, just another way the pandemic is ruining everyone's fun.
Also, what ruined that is Ring doorbell. Yeah. How easy and a little expense all cameras are. Like, you can't. My kids will never get away with skipping school and going home. That used to be a thing. Like, my buddy the Wizard, both his parents worked all the time. So when we'd skip high school or whatever, we'd just go to his house and hang out. Mm-hmm. You know, his parents didn't get home till 5.
But was his house near the school?
Yeah, yeah.
See, we always had, and you know what's funny is I've asked Andrea, different people, different generations at DeLand High. It's like almost a tradition that you find a friend whose house is almost walkable from the school, and that's where you hang out.
Yeah,
and
it's
generational. It never changes. You know, I'm sure there are kids right now in school that skip and then walk to their friend's house that lives near DeLand High. It's just going to be that way until we all go virtual and the society, there's no more buildings.
I feel like teens are just doing whatever they want anyway. They'll find a way.
Yeah,
but always.
They're all partying. I see them on Snapchat.
It's harder to, like, think about when my sons get teenage years, they'll have a cell phone. And for sure, my wife will be watching where they are, verifying where
she's
they are.
She's a good mom.
Through cell phone tracker technology. Yeah. She does it with me. And of course, she could do it with my sons.
Yeah, but those kids, they'll learn the ways to get around it. You won't, your old pop-up. But they'll figure it out.
You know what sucks?
Is it some sort of like hack? Is there a way to do
that? You know what?
Put it in airplane mode, bro.
You know what sucks is Tommy's gonna have a hard go, and I'll tell you why. Because he's gonna have the knowledge, and he's gonna have the creativity.
But he's a rule follower
to figure out the way to backdoor some stuff. That, I mean, he'll think at it a different way, like interdisciplinary style ways. I feel like, because he's so creative, and he's gonna find a way to skip. That love of not wanting to skip is gonna hold, because he's gonna have all the power.
Oh yeah,
but no, none of the want.
He'll write the book, but won't do it.
He'll never, break the rules.
I wonder if Max will be like, "Hey, show me your ways."
Yeah,
you know, like that's what I'm worried about.
Peer pressure.
Yeah, it's probably gonna happen. You want to do another voicemail?
Yeah,
let's go, Christrema.
Hey, Sam, Tom, Dan, Butler. It is Christrema. I was listening to the OG recap and. You're speaking of the tail end of the fact that people used to put disposable cameras on the tables at the wedding. My husband and I got married in 2010, and we did that. And we're so bad at life that we never even developed the photos. So I'm glad to hear that they were all just pictures of dick holes and nothing good because we never got them developed. So anyway, love y'all. Bye.
Yeah, a lot of dick hole pictures.
Yeah.
It's a bold move, just the dick hole.
Yeah. I think I meant to take a picture of my whole penis.
got too close.
Yeah.
By the way, too, you're paying.
How would I have known that disposable camera busted in a lie?
I remember screaming, we're paying, like, I think we didn't do it, or her dad did, but it was like $5,000 for a photographer. Right. Like, it's insanely expensive for wedding pictures. Mm-hmm. And, like, you're paying, and then you're just putting these disposable
trash
cameras.
Trash disposable. With all your drunk friends. Yeah,
that's true.
What quality pictures?
No, terrible. Like,
and maybe if we didn't have a photographer,
my
then this
wife
was the other
said
option.
It
okay.
was to get pictures Stupid. From the people enjoying the day's perspective. I nixed it and we didn't do it. You want to know why we didn't do it? Because my good friend Tom Van said, don't fucking do that. It's fucking stupid.
Yeah.
And I listened to him. Because there are certain things that he knows. Mm. You got another email? And I got one more voicemail.
This says, there's no way Tom pays to park his boat. I'm pretty sure I've heard Tom or Crystal mention taking their boat to Blue Springs, and I love Tom, but what are the chances that he pays the correct fee every time?
In the little honor
it's
system
like,
box?
Yeah. It's like 0%, right? Since he's an irredeemable scumbag,
oh,
I decided
on.
To do
oh,
the gentlemanly
harsh.
Thing
that's
and throw harsh. In an extra 10 last weekend to cover his ass. And he did show a sign that says, welcome to Blue Springs State Park. Park admission fees, $2 per visitor. Please use blue envelope and keep receipts. And so do you pay $2 per person, or do you do a $2 per vehicle? Because that's
not you're an $8 boat all day long, buddy.
Well, hold on.
You're $8 van.
I just slide in an empty envelope. I'm like,
that's a good chopper move.
Kids under 5 should be free.
No,
that's not the rules, buddy.
At IHOP and Denny's.
Their little feet are trampling around that whole state park. They got to pay.
I don't know about it. I mean, it's mainly about...
Man, Sam's a mean-ass ranger.
it's about the...
Only 5 traffic classes, and those kids got to pay.
The spirit of it. Now, I will admit, back when I lived in Deltona, and me and my wife used to go there in the old mildew boat.
I went there with you once.
Things weren't as good for old Tom
I went
Van,
there
so
with you one time, and we did not pay. So
out there, and then
just being honest, dude.
Also, I'm not like utilizing.
We made
your,
jokes about it. We were like, and then you were like, just pretend to play. Yeah. And I'm like, okay,
oh,
putting them in.
This is one there walking around a little bit to go back in, go back to my boat. It's like, how much is that worth? Come back, give me a break. I pay a lot of taxes, and that kind of should bleed into Volusia County, right?
If you had to guess, have you paid?
I know it's not the same.
Have you paid?
I do pay now.
Have you evened it up?
And I just put whatever I have in there, and sometimes it's...
Sometimes it's $1,000. It's crazy.
I was about to say, sometimes it's a dollar more, sometimes it's $5 less. It all evens out.
What?
Before we... Okay, you have one more
voicemail. I got one more voicemail. Sorry. You want to do that? Yeah, okay, we'll do one more voicemail. Here we go. With this guy. Oh, damn it. Hit the wrong button. Let's try it this way.
Daniel, what happened with you making Madonna's Vogue in Tom's voice? I was listening to the old BDM show, and you... You said you're going to do that over Christmas, and then we've never heard it. What's going on?
There you go.
Well, Dan says a million things, we can't keep track of them all.
I have too much going on, sir. But I whipped up something for you this morning.
Yes.
Because I am a giver.
Surprise song.
I hate disappointing people. It's not the whole song.
Really?
I just gave you...
One of my favorite things.
I just gave you a little piece. So it's not the whole thing. I don't have time for the whole thing. But hopefully this will wet your whistle and ease you into the first break on this fine Friday.
Buggy way.
Buggy way.
Buggy way.
Beauty is where you find it. Buggy way.
Buggy way.
Buggy way.
Beauty is where you find it. Greta Garbo and Monroe, Dotrick and DiMaggio, Marlon Brando, Jimmy D, Fat Guy, Sausage King, Claw, Hands, Alarm God, John, Rims Round Table. Is that still on? Gene, Simmons, Fred, Durst, if it weren't for ladies, I'm balls with birth. What is stop? What is great? Crow is all up in my face. Daniel, Sam, Butler, too. I can't say I love you. N-words with an attitude. Fellas that were in the mood. Don't just stand there. Let's get to it. Gotta strike that pose. There's nothing to it. Vogue you in.
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 Oh, you've got to do.
It's Vogue you in.
Let your body move. Voice for music.
Vogue you in.
Oh, you've got to just Watch her body go.
Come on, man. Buggy way.
Whoa, whoa. You just got to just.
Just add that to every song. It's a big snort.
Why is
it funny? It's
Buggy Way.
By the way, all of us are idiots for laughing at that. And everybody,
you don't know how to read Vogue.
You're just laughing because
that's funny.
With a foghorn at the end. And they're like, how stupid are we?
We're trying to have a fun Friday.
I'm just saying. I'm mad that my response is. Crazy laughter.
Why is it so funny?
Yeah.
You proves how stupid.
It's Foggy Way, man.
God damn it. It's just proof of how stupid we are, right? It's like, there's no way around it.
One more, and
you just got to just.
If I heard that in the middle of the night, I'd be fucking terrified. All right, you want to take a break?
Yeah, let's do it.
It's not my best work. But sometimes your best work still has value, right?
Sometimes your best work's your worst work.
All right, brand new music today. Let's see. I got good stuff today, man. We've been getting I think all these quarantine songs, remember my prediction was that we're going to get like a renaissance of new music that's coming out, and man, we're getting a lot of good stuff to play. So we've got the Luke Estate today coming out of the break. We've got brand new single from Death From Above 1979. I love those
Ooh,
guys.
Me too.
Yeah, they're killer. So here's the Luke Estate. The song's called Insert Girl's Name Here. We'll be right back with more Mediocre Time with Tom and Dan. 1-844-TOM, the letter N, D-A-N. Bye bye. It's our buddies Gringos Locos, the official taco provider, and delicious Gringos.
Now
I want some.
We usually have koozies and magnets at like the Milk District location.
And I like that we do that. We pick two products that you honestly you don't even use them anymore. Magnets. Nobody puts pictures on their refrigerator in a koozie.
Magnets for your car.
Let's be real with the koozies.
Well, listen, you need a koozie for your beer.
I don't think it does it either. I think it warms my beer. I think it warms every. If you put a koozie on a nice cold White Claw, all you're doing is putting a sweater on your White Claw.
You're
just warming it.
Our listeners, they drink.
Don't get one of these.
They drink so fast. Like me, I throw my can away. It's so cold. Like what? Anyway,
they're great koozies.
This is the first time we've had koozies and magnets at every Gringo's location in Central Florida. And all you have to do is when you're checking out at the register,
you just got
to
ask one of the sweeties there making your burrito. Hopefully they'll know that they're there.
Yeah. And they'll just say, hey, can I have a Tom and Dan magnet or koozie? They'll give it to you. Yeah. If you get it to go when you go pick it up. Ask for the koozie and magnet. Now, here's the problem. If you order it on, like, Uber Eats then it's like you put in the notes that could be missed. So, if you're there at the store.
Try it.
Yeah, put
really
in the notes.
You really want to piss off that Uber Eats person.
I think they may...
God, a koozie guy. I put my dick in his koozie. I was driving to your house, I put my dick in your koozie.
And
people don't use those.
So, if you're at a different Gringo's location. Now, there's multiple. There's one downtown. There's one by in the Milk District.
I hit the Michigan location.
Yeah, Michigan Avenue.
Very tasty.
UCF location. So
catering, big or small, for parties?
Yeah.
In fact, that's really... I've graduated.
Dude,
I don't
like
go
a Super Bowl get together.
I'm an adult, Tom. Mm. I don't go downtown to drink and then wander over to one of these restaurants. Mm. I'm an adult now. I have big, fancy adult parties.
I
hire Gringos. That's what adults do.
Yeah.
I bring the party to me.
Yeah. And they'll just give you a party pack if you want. Do full catering if you want. All the information is at gringoslocos.com.
Well,
Welcome back to A Mediocre Time with Tom and Dan. I am Dan.
I'm Tom. Uh-oh.
No, Ross is just setting up his computer equipment.
Oh, no,
he's got a very sophisticated system. That's his new news generator.
Uh-oh.
Yeah.
No, it's trash can junket. No,
it's the end of the band. That was old Death from Above 1979 with One Plus One. I do have a new intro for Ross that we're going to debut right now.
All right.
And he looks handsome as ever. You want to do some news?
Let's do it.
Ross's piece of shit news.
Ross's news brought to you by Mike's Hard Lemonade Hard Seltzer. Mm-hmm. Now, don't get it confused with a regular Mike's Hard Lemonade can.
Gotta get the seltzer.
A bunch of people, now, those are great too, but a bunch of people have been like, this is not what you described, Tom. I'm like, you're buying the wrong product. It's the hard seltzer.
Yeah.
Anyway. How you doing, Ross?
Oh, man, that stuff puts me right in the mood for some advanced fingering, I'll tell you what.
Advanced.
In fact, we...
Oh, yeah, we made a concoction
here. Yeah, so my new thing has been figuring out, because... Ross, you know that White Claw is actually the parent company is Mike's Hard Lemonade. You are aware of that, right?
Yes, yeah. I believe August had mentioned that at one point.
Yeah. And
he
then,
watches To Catch a Predator.
And then so Mike's Hard Lemonade came out with their own hard seltzer. Now, of course, the flavors are just like the same company as White Claw. We've been telling you White Claw does it right with their flavors.
They do.
And so we started mixing the Mike's Hard Lemonade Hard Seltzer with some White Claw. And
so what flavors do we got in here?
I know exactly what he made because it tastes just like it.
So I'm calling this one the Sprite, and this is a White Claw Lime.
Okay.
And a Mike's Hard Seltzer Lemon. And then mixed together.
It does taste like Sprite.
It's a hard Sprite.
So if I mix this with...
smells like Sprite.
So if I mix this with Canadian...
It tastes exactly like Sprite.
So if I mix this with Canadian whiskey,
wow,
like my W.A. In my family, there is, on my dad's side of the family, my cousin W.H., William Henry, he is the tobaccoman. And his favorite drink still talks like my dad. He likes Sprite and Canadian whiskey on ice.
Ooh.
Ooh, this would hurt you.
Yeah.
This would hurt.
Dude,
A doubled up one, right?
Yeah, this is the first time I've had it. I was like, wonder what
it tastes just like Sprite.
Yeah. Anyway,
you're mixing hard seltzers as a cocktail now, Tom. I have never been happier that Pop Up was dead.
I know.
Oh, yeah.
He's happy too, especially I'd be very upset about
I'm pretty glad I checked out before the old seltzer craze.
Yeah. And I could be, you'd have some comments about a woman in the White House. We'd be very mad about that. Anyway.
Did Joe Biden change his pronouns? What's wrong?
You know. Anyway, so.
They, them.
All right, what do we got?
Yeah. What's up the story?
You guys want to hear a story before we get to the next?
Yes. Mm-hmm. Yes.
So I went to this local seafood establishment called Crimson Crustacean on Monday.
Okay.
And, yeah, I've been to the old Crimson Crustacean.
That's one of my top three restaurants to avoid at all costs. And I did get like kind of sour belly from it. I'm blaming the coconut shrimp. The coconut shrimp went down like a fucking, like those crosses they put out on D-Day to keep the Americans off the fucking beach. Right?
Yeah.
And so I've had a little bit of a bellyache all week. Last night, like 2-3 in the morning, I wake up, I got sour belly. I go, I take a dump. And I hopped in the shower because sometimes like a hot shower will refresh that sour belly and just make it go away, you know?
All right.
And I'm in the shower and my fucking back starts aching. It just starts aching and it won't go away. And like cut to like 3 hours later, I'm still in the shower. The hot water's been gone for hours. And I'm like laying on the floor of my tub. And when I put it together, I was on the floor of the tub just trying to pee. I'm trying to like pee and force the pee out. And I'm like, and I'm moaning and I'm like, it feels like I'm trying to give birth to this fucking pee. And that's when I put it together. I think I had a kidney stone. And so, it was bad until like 7 a.m. this morning. I got a doctor's appointment. I took some ibuprofen. I finally got like an hour's sleep. And when I woke up to go to the doctor's, I rocked a massive piss. And then I got to the doctor's and they did a urine sample and they found blood in my urine. So they think,
oh man,
I probably passed it. And it like, scraped up the urethra on the way out.
Oh, that's good. You didn't feel that?
Oh my god.
There's for some reason kidney stones aren't smooth like river rocks. They're like those little
jagged, spiky, they're like shark teeth.
I wanted a skipping pebble.
They're like those Florida spiky balls that get on the bottom of your jeans.
Sand spurs. Yeah. That's what we called them.
So when you pass them, it's and then you pass out. Apparently,
I think my dad used to get these. You know, and he just like scream, piss one out in the morning, and then go to work. You know, he's like, you get in a car and he's selling tax guides to all the, you know, he'd have his coffee, he'd just scream one out. I'm serious, Ross. I believe my dad would just be like, bah! And then he'd get in his Buick LeSabre and off to sell things.
My pop-up got kidney stones one time, and I had to take him to get him pulverized by the ultrasound.
Oh, I thought you were going to say by NBC's Dwayne Johnson, The Rock.
So, and I took him, and then he had to have this, it's like a ultrasound that shoots sonic waves into your kidneys that pulverizes the kidney stones into smaller kidney stones, so you could pass them all out. And then, and remember, he had bruises, like, all over, because it actually, you know, bruises the skin or whatever. It looked horribly. Never complained one bit.
No, of course not. He's a real man.
Literally went there, got a bruise. I'm like, oh my god! He's mowing his lawn.
You know what my version of that was? Because anytime I get sick, I'm like, what would they do if this was like Little House on the Prairie times or whatever? You know, you can't. There's no doctors around. I don't think they had this on the prairie, but we have a fucking one of those percussive massagers.
Yep.
And I put that fucker on my kidneys for a while.
Oh,
really? Beating him good.
God, he's like expediting the pain. He's like, give me more.
We can get a local boxer to just kidney punch you until you blood pee him out.
Honestly, God, though, like, I've always heard that thing, like, it feels like giving birth, and that's when I put it together. I was like laying on the bathtub floor, and I was like, I was making noises, like, ah!
Well, I hope you feel better now, man. My God.
What is it?
How do you get those, or is it just hereditary?
My wife's been looking into it. She says it's calcium deposits, and, you know, it's just one of those fucking things that happens.
I hope the doctor's like, have you been drinking any coffee or champagne? It's like, that's what I only drink. They're like, oh, okay, there it is.
You know what? It's been a while, Tom. I've been off coffee for like 2 years now. I can't drink it anymore.
Really?
It makes me nervous and like and shaky and I can't do it anymore.
Yeah, weird. Tom's on coffee now. Seriously.
Yeah.
He actually drinks coffee now.
I have every morning now. I have one cup of coffee. Really, I think I use it as an excuse. I'm like, it's helping my filter my liver from the alcohol. I read some Facebook story that one cup of coffee a day helps get the stuff out.
The toxins.
That doesn't work if you make it with Mike's Hard Lemonade Seltzer.
He does cut it. Oh man, it's good.
The hot lemon.
All right, Ross, what do we got for our first story?
All right, let's talk about, let's go to France. I don't know. How many people do you think is an orgy? What's an orgy to you?
Ooh, that's a great question.
I got the exact answer. So anything over five.
That's what I would say, too.
Is considered an orgy.
Is five an orgy? Is it five and over over five?
I say five and over.
Because
don't
four.
Five people and over. Don't say five.
Right, correct.
And over.
Yeah.
Four can be couple swapping.
Yeah,
could be.
That's a thing.
You know, like, you
swinging.
Know,
I've never wanted to do the couple swapping. I don't feel like there are enough options, and I don't want to be left with the Hmong.
But you can't. If you get into six people, then that's beyond couple swapping. And then, so it's five is, you know,
do you want an even
six.
Number? Or do you want to know? Does it matter? I would imagine you'd want an even number, right? So everybody has somebody to.
Well, two can work on one. Cuff,
yeah. Well, that's the thing. Two's a couple. Three's a threesome. Four is couple swapping. Five's an orgy. And anything above five is an orgy.
Is that how you taught your kids to count?
I don't know how to factor in bukkake in there because that's a weird. I don't know what that is.
Yeah. Does anybody even want that? And why did they give it a fancy name?
That's just,
I think cum face fits better.
That's just some
bukkake
stunting.
Like,
that's stunting.
Yeah. It's like
stunting.
It's as if, you know, like Viennetta is still ice cream.
Right. Yeah. Those are back, but
yeah, they are.
So anyway, what's the correct answer, Ross?
So in France, the police just got a report of a giant party that came to break it up.
Yep.
They found what they're calling an orgy of 81 people.
I saw this story. Yeah, I had a feeling you would snag this one, dude, because like. And they've been, and didn't they, did they say in what you read that they've been doing this for like a while, right?
I don't know if it was a regular party type thing. One article I saw said that the cops showed up at 9 and they couldn't get in until 11. So, you know, a lot of partying can take place in those 2 hours. They took a bunch of alcohol, sound and light equipment. For any good orgy, you need the fucking light show. And and they arrested or fined 80 plus people.
The weird thing about
that's
orgies,
because of COVID, right? Not yeah. because
COVID curfew. Correct. That's yeah, what I think.
The weird thing about orgies to me is that any of the orgies that I've ever seen online, and that's the only access I've ever had to orgies. You know, I've never been to a real one.
Well, I didn't know they go on. And close in Jamaica, right? I mean, we saw live,
but still, okay. What I'm about to say still applies. They're very sweaty. And I think I would like to find an orgy that's a little more Tom Cruise eyes wide mm-hmm. shut, uh-huh. where it's a dry orgy.
Okay, yeah.
I would prefer a dry mm-hmm. orgy to a greasy, sweaty orgy. But most yeah. orgies are greasy, sweaty.
Yeah, yeah. Because they're not like portrayed in the movie. In the movie, you're walking through a mansion. There's a bunch of people with red silk. you know, and they're like having passionate sex.
Well, not even passionate, just clean. Yeah. You know, like everybody's dry. Like they've been freshly powdered.
There's no like fat redneck guy jacking his limp dick.
Yeah,
yeah. There's a one of them. It's like, oh, come on.
That guy's the ruiner. Yeah.
By the way, camera guy, how about you just don't show that guy?
Yeah. Why don't we see that guy? Yeah. Yeah, can you tighten the shot? Yeah. Tighten the shot. Even if it's on a butthole, tighten
mind
the shot.
Your shots. Yeah,
yeah. I don't want to see the fat guy jerking it.
And then just tell him to leave the room. Yeah. He's like, yeah, you're not doing anything.
Well, just kick him out of the fucking orgy. Why is he even there? He's eating all the finger sandwiches.
Sorry.
There's a guy down in Kissimmee for a little while that had a comedy room that was associated with the Swingers Club. And one time me and Big Tim did a show down there and they were all gross. They were all 100% gross people.
Yeah, yeah.
Tim, I think the quote from Big Tim, I was like, oh, dude, you did comedy at an orgy? He's like, it was bad, baby.
There's, yeah.
I think he was just matter of fact, like, Tim, I'm never talking about it. You know, like, shut the fuck up, Daniel.
That guy was famous for trying to pay you with squeezing his wife's tits. And I was just like, just give me my $20.
Right. How good were the tits?
I like that he's like,
one good squeeze?
Hey, I know you did. Hey, great set tonight, McCoy.
Now grab this.
Which
set.
Is it? 20 or you want to grab these bags?
By the way, if you lined up a bunch of local comedians, I could tell you which took the squeeze tits.
Oh, yeah.
For sure. Within 80% accuracy.
Oh my God. Ross set it up. It's a great online game show. Who squeezed the tits
for the payment? Because I'll tell you. I'll be that's a, for sure.
Oh my God!
What else we got?
I think my favorite story this week. We got a guy in Oklahoma proposing Bigfoot hunting season.
Okay. Right.
They apparently have a Bigfoot festival and. Representative Justin Humphrey wants to create a license that you can buy, and he's trying to get he's trying to make it like a hunting and trapping license, so you can put a fucking Bigfoot trap. No way that can go wrong, right? A man-sized trap. Just
oh
on the
my
level.
God! Yeah.
No kids will fall.
And,
into that.
He wants to. He's trying to raise funds to put up a $25,000 bounty for the first person to catch a Bigfoot in Oklahoma.
So, God, it goes back to me and Daniel's theory, Ross, and it's like the flat Earth, the Bigfoot, the all these old school, the goddamn Loch Ness monster, and these
that's
these
a good
things.
One.
And
I forget about the Loch Ness one. I think, namely, because it's not a traditional North American type mm-hmm. of deal, right?
Ross,
some people are saying now that could be a giant turtle.
What do you think the percentage? Okay, say everybody who goes to the 2021 Bigfoot Festival. How many of those
people...
It's like
going to Zellwood Corn Festival, yeah, right?
How many of those people who attend that festival, like, honestly believe that there is a Bigfoot out there, or at least a huge possibility that there is what we know as Bigfoot wandering around the woods Ooh. Of Oklahoma? Like, I just think...
You gotta figure it's 50% Bigfoot enthusiasts, and then 50% their wives that get dragged there.
Oh, yeah. My God, yeah. The wives of the Bigfoot.
It's Tom and Dan math. 50% the guys that are interested, and 50% the wives that got dragged there. I mean, like, we've seen that, and then they normally stay, but they're not staying for the Bigfoot thing, though.
But even of the guys that are interested in the festival, do you think the majority literally believe that this is true, or
I don't think they do.
They're into the concept, the camaraderie. No, I don't the
think.
Joke,
yeah, I think they're in. Yeah. They're in on the joke. Like Ross, I got hit up this week, and maybe you did too. Tots with Ross. If you're not subscribed to Ross's podcast, you should do so now. You may get hit up too, and I got hit up by these same flat Earth guys, and they're like, "We want to come on," and I'm like,
"Oh yeah,"
but I know you don't. Believe-
did they like message you through a luxury pen brand or something like
yeah,
that?
Yeah, like a weird way.
It
yes.
was weird, right?
Yeah, it's yeah. very odd, and I'm like, but I know you don't believe it. Like, yeah. I know...
Yeah, this is all some sort
I know
of troll.
This is fake, and you're trying to just steal my airtime, you know? Like,
I hit those guys back. I was like, sure, come talk nonsense on my fucking show. I don't care.
No, I did too, but I didn't get anything back. I mean, like, I'll do it. I mean, I'll set it up. And
at this point, I'm not, like, at first, I was curious to find out whether they actually believed or not. And now I'm more and more convinced that no one, like, maybe there's some yahoos. And I got to give it to you. The guy that rocketed himself to death, like, he probably believed.
Guy.
He had commitment, at least. Yeah. He was willing to
die for it.
But that then, I mean, that will stop the other guys that were like next in line, right?
Well, for getting in a rocket. For
no,
sure.
But I mean, I think you second.
Like, I'm not doing that.
I mean, I think you second guess it. You're seeing a lot of that now with any belief in the world. You see it explode, you know, without going into it. You see things explode, and then you see people like, go, they back up, and they're like, oh, shit.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know
maybe
why.
Maybe I need to rethink
this whole
thing.
Maybe I shouldn't have been into that.
It's like any religion. You're like, if you're willing to die for it, and then it slowly dilutes to, like, I like these things and not so much these things.
Yeah, pick and choose.
That's true. What else you got?
All right, since we're on religion, let's talk about, I believe this is Poughkeepsie, New York. Recently just got burned down, their most famous Church of Satan.
Oh, my God. That makes it better, right?
They call it in this article an Adams family style house. I guess it's like an old, you know, fucking old house. And they got surveillance footage. A guy walked up to the house at 5 a.m. Thursday, had two gas cans, splashed it all around the porch and fucking lit it on fire. There were people in the house. Everybody got unharmed. And then we got the quotes from the Satanists.
All right.
The guy used to be the house used to be owned by Joe Netherworld Mendilo. He died last year. He's described.
Hold on. Netherworld reminds me of nether regions for whatever reason, which reminds me of balls. Like every single time. Say underworld, not netherworld. Anyway, sorry.
They call this guy a dark side Martha Stewart, right?
Oh, I love that.
He loved giving away candy on Halloween to the kids, and he had like a bunch of Satan statues out in the yard and stuff, and he kind of tried to make himself an emissary for the devil, and they just burned his house down. And
while people were inside,
well, they liked that. Yeah,
I'll teach you to believe in Satan. I'll murder you to burn you to death. Like, all right.
One of these Satanists reached for comment about this. Said, "I believe, unironically, quote, whoever did this is going to be hexed by all of us. Now there's going to be hell to pay."
That's fantastic.
Well, I think they would already have been targeted by the devil for believing it. And they seem like they're probably mad that these people are Satanists. And therefore, I'm assuming they're maybe ultra-Christian or something.
Have you ever met anybody that told you they truly believed in the Church of Satan?
Yes. Well,
I have not.
And they're very nice people. And most of them are just atheists.
Yeah, I was about to say that.
So
They're just fucking around.
Yeah, I was going to say, I haven't met anybody that's like really into
it. It's not based on devil worship.
But I have, I can't see why it would be a problem.
It's like the joke, and I don't know if Richard Dawkins got this from this, like the spaghetti monster joke, where it's like, I believe in the spaghetti monster. You're basically semi-mocking everybody else by saying you believe in this, and I think that's the same thing that Satanists are doing.
And rights to religious freedom, right?
So, yeah, and they're like,
don't burn down my church.
I do agree with that. Yeah. I mean, there's some really weird...
But again, it's like Bigfoot. Nobody really actually believes that the devil is some sort of deity or whatever.
Yeah, you just might have a series of rules that maybe you align with a little bit more to guide your life.
I think it's more of they're just trolling Christians, right?
No, I know some people that actually, like, it kind of bleeds into that weird, like, Wicca, you know, the actual Church of
Black Magic or something.
Yeah, but what I'm saying is that they have guidelines of, like, from what I gathered, Ross, you might know a little bit about this. From what I gathered mostly from satanic stuff that I have, you know, read about when I get really high, it's weird, I go dark places, I'll start reading it, and most of it's like, You are in charge of your life. You right. are in charge of your being. You are the
Do what thou wilt shall be the whole of the law.
Yeah, like you're a god on earth. Like you yeah. have been given this, and the way that they believe is that, like, yeah, the world is yours for the taking. You know, it's almost like there's a selfishness to it.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, well,
from what I've read, and that's okay. You know, whatever you want to believe in, as long as you're not hurting kids.
It's like a naturalist or an atheist tattoo, but like, do they believe that there's a devil that with a pitchfork?
No, we know, Tom. None of your Miami friends are saying this. Okay, the hard thing
I want to know if they actually believe in the molten lava and the lake.
It's do what thou wilt should be the whole of the law, non-surveyum. Then you get into like the real fucking cool Philip K. Dick weirdo, like the real God is God that we recognize from the Bible of Abraham. That's not the real God. That's the devil. And the real God is trying to, like, help us through all that. There's levels to this shit, man.
Oh, okay, we read the same stuff sometimes when we get high. Just text me when you're up.
Dude, I got this fucking book for you. It's called Valis. It's Vast Active Living Information System. Philip K. Dick, the guy that wrote Do Androids Dream of Electric Sheep? That became...
I'll write it down. Yeah. Hand me your pencil, Tom.
No.
And it's about this fucking... spaceship god that shoots information in your brain with pink lasers. Fucking awesome.
I like that.
What is it? Is it like a science fiction book?
Here's the thing. Philip K. Dick was a science fiction author. About halfway, he calls the main character in this book Horse Lover Fat. And about halfway through the book, he reveals that means Philip in German is horse lover and Dick is fat. So the character in the book is him the whole time. And this character keeps getting fucking laser beams shot into his brain that give him information that he couldn't have otherwise, and he can prove it. And Philip K. Dick also, I think, went crazy. So,
no, right.
If you want spicy books, just go to Ross. Not the store, the person.
What's the next story?
All right, what do we got here? Bigfoot, we talked about that. Oh, a guy in New Jersey convicted of robbing a bank. His conviction got overturned. He was convicted of robbing this bank, and the prosecutor wanted to make a point. A lot of the witnesses specifically said he didn't say or do anything threatening specifically, and the prosecutor wanted to make a point that you could threaten somebody without saying something threatening. So he played a clip from The Shining, that clip where Jack Nicholson chops through the door with an axe and says, "Here's Johnny." He played that clip in court to kind of prove, in his mind anyway, that you could say something non-threatening and be threatening while doing it.
Mm-hmm.
And because of that, the conviction got overturned.
Wow.
They basically ruled that showing a scene that everybody recognizes this guy as a bad character, and you know, just from memes and stuff, you know that this is not a good guy. By showing that and equating it with the defendant, that this prosecutor fucked up.
Wow.
Huh.
So
that's wild.
Oh, it got overturned because they did it court procedures wrong, right? Not because
technicality type stuff.
Because I thought,
oh no, dude robbed the bank.
Because even if
it happened.
Even if you stand at the super polite, you hand a note that says, "Please, can I have your money?"
Like
that's considered a threat, a violence or whatever. Even asking please is like.
And there's the other one too. If you're sitting in the getaway car with your driving gloves on, with the engine running, about to drive your friend away, suddenly you're in trouble. I didn't kill anybody. I just drove away from the people he killed.
What?
It's like, last time I checked, my license was good, and I did the speed limit. I just took weird roads.
I don't know what he did.
I just drove through one school playground. I was slow. He was slow, and I navigated around the kids.
In my WRX, I'm drifting up.
I drove that car so bad from Orlando City Stadium when I came here to pick up our passes. I had to drive.
Now, if the prosecutor showed footage of Need for Speed, you'd be off the hook.
I think we told the story on the show before, but we met this guy that supposedly robbed a bank.
On the cruise.
On a cruise, an old monster cruise.
Yeah.
And he told us, he's like, "I did this in the 70s. I was hard on, and it's like, I only got like..."
Do you remember talking to him at the back of the boat?
Yeah, it was like
he had a bandage on his face.
Mm-hmm.
He had like a bandage on his face. I don't know if you remember that.
No, I don't. I remember details.
Yeah, he had like old people that have done some shit always have one injury that will never heal. That's a fact. That's science.
I was on a lot of mushrooms that cruise. I was seeing a lot of shit on a lot of people's faces.
Yeah, this was like old people that have done some shit will have like a finger that always has a Band-Aid on it, something on their face, like a wart on their neck that always has a Band-Aid on it, like a perpetual Band-Aid for life.
So you're saying that Nelly is old.
Oh, well, right. he is now. A little bit. The lunatics, though, they're good.
Street sweeper.
So, is there any, there's statute of limitations with robbing a bank?
I would imagine there is.
It's a federal, I think it may not be.
I think the only thing that does not have a statute of limitations is murder.
Murder is correct.
And so there is, if you robbed a bank in the 70s or something, and like they found out 20 years later.
They wouldn't even be investigating it 20 years later.
Well, I'm just saying, what if you admitted and like, I was this robber?
I think you're fine.
Well, Ross, I don't know if you saw this. I'm sure you saw this. It was everywhere. The guy who everybody thought, including the FBI, was, what's his name? Jumped out of the plane.
D.B. Cooper.
Yeah. Thank you, D.B. Cooper. That guy, I think he died this week.
What?
And he went on the record, like, I believe on his deathbed, of saying, you can Google this, Sam, of saying, like, the FBI was interested in me, and they had good reason to be interested in me. You know, like, and I'm like, what's the story? Are you the guy? And then they show his picture next to the drawing, and I'm like, God damn it, that's D.B. Cooper.
But his name wasn't D.B. Cooper. No.
It was Sheridan Peterson. He died at 94 on January 8th.
Yeah. That now, just happened, man.
Could he, because that is a good prank if you're like around the same age as D.B. Cooper.
That's the ultimate long con.
And you worked, like,
that's a dead long con.
You lived, like, you start putting things in your, like, I could be D.B. Cooper. I'm going to, right before I die, I'm just going to say,
yeah,
I'm
not.
And then you fucking
that's
die.
A great idea.
And then for the rest of, you know, no one knows. And then
so
they said, yeah.
He served in the U.S. Marine Corps during World War II. He was an experienced smoke jumper. Yeah. Loves skydiving and taking risks.
This is the guy. He had all the military knowledge to pull off this out of the back, jump away with the money D.B. Cooper thing. Only somebody that served for our country and had extensive badass training. You're like back in that day, you're not going to be doing that shit for a hobby in the, 1940, 50s?
How would you train for it? Yeah.
Yeah, you wouldn't do. So I'm just
saying. You'd have to be an experienced skydiver or whatever.
Well, that's only become like the thing now. You know what I mean? It's a thing now.
Yes, yeah, yeah.
Did he have any proof? Like, because I know I've seen lists of the bills that he took with the serial numbers. They're, you know, if you find one of those, you can auction it off for a lot of fucking money. And so did he have any like bills or anything to prove it?
Sam, I didn't dig into it.
I'm just reading this one article that the first one I read, and I haven't got to any of that yet, but it basically is saying, like, this guy was a great guy. He built schools. He helped establish freedom schools in the Deep South.
He built it with the wrong
with exactly. He might have.
No, but that's what they go into in another article. They talk about, like, there were times when he just had the money. You know what I mean? He just had the cow. He built it. Like, I don't know. It's an interesting story. Somebody should take it, whether it's true or not. Maybe make it a positive movie. Make it a movie. I'll leave.
You know what I'm mad about?
He said, actually, the FBI had good reason to suspect me. Yeah. He wrote in a 2007 issue of Smoke Jumper, a magazine published by National Smoke Jumper Association. Friends and associates agreed that I was without a doubt D.B. Cooper. There were too many circumstances involved for it to be a coincidence.
Doesn't that sound like somebody who is D.B. Cooper?
And then before he died?
He said at the time of the heist, I was 44 years old. That was the approximate age Cooper was assumed to have been. I closely resemble sketches of the hijacker.
Do you look at the picture, Sam? Look at the picture.
Not yet, but yeah, what was more incriminating was the photo of me simulating a skydiving maneuver for Boeing's news sheet. I was wearing a suit and tie, the same sort of garb Cooper had worn, right down to the Oxford loafers. It was noted that skydivers don't ordinarily dress so formally. There's no picture associated with this article, but I'll look for
it. The one that I had, they have a picture of him with the drawing, with the sunglass drawing, you know, and you're like, well, that's the fucking guy.
So no one could.
Ross put his shades on. You should always wear those, man.
First,
we should crowdfund the old yellow glasses back. Those are so cool.
There's two things. First, I'm mad at this old man for not just saying, because now he's dead. And now
he's way cooler than
just
you.
Just tell us, old man, are you D.B. Cooper or not? Stop with this, oh, it could be or not going to die. You're about to die. No one's going to arrest you. Now you're old as hell. No,
I don't think he actually was, but I think he was saying, like, you know, there were reasons for them to believe. I understand why people suspected me, kind of thing. thing.
Tom, that's what you take away from this? I'm signing up for Smoke Jumper magazine right now.
That's terrifying.
Oh, man. Butler threw it. And you do want to say, just say that, because that's actually an interesting
tidbit. There was a crazy story recently I saw on CNN about this, so I don't know if the truth to this, but it was a lady who just recently died. She claimed, the record show that she was like 120 whatever, but she claims that she sold like pastels to Van Gogh and all these other crazy like artifacts. Like, this lady's lived throughout some crazy history in her life. And interesting. And
this lady's saying she sold like paints to Van Gogh. You know, like, it's like maybe we should all do that when we get old enough. I don't
know. Why
not? I'll say something.
Make shit up.
So yeah. She.
I'll make something up.
They had her down as being 120.
I gave.
Yeah, but like, it was easy to falsify records back in the day. So, I mean, sure. Who knows how old she was.
I gave Dustin Diamond the knife to stab in that bar.
Is there any.
He does look like. The sketch.
It looks exactly like the sketch. It's like, it almost looks like the guy got away with it and then realized that he got away with it because it'd been like, what, 50 years?
The hair, the forehead.
Yeah, and then he's like, nothing can happen to me. I'm just going to keep alluding to it and drive you insane until I die.
Although all 1950s white guys look the same to me.
No, this guy's got a huge head.
Oh, yeah. Okay.
He's got a five head.
Yeah.
Yeah.
He's DB
Ross. Do you know? is there any way for science or doctors to tell how old you are within a
count
year?
The rings.
No, something like, can you tell how old a human is within a year without the, you know, actually knowing the, you know, the date of birth?
As far as I know, no.
Okay, well, I figured you could get close, right?
It's related, unrelated.
Some bones?
You know what I hate?
Teeth, right? That's what they do with murder cases.
Yeah, teeth or bone, yeah.
I can get approximate.
That proves who you are, but I don't think it can prove how old you are.
There is a way to find out, because they'll get like Jane Does and shit, and they'll be like, approximately this age and this age.
Samantha knows about murder. I should ask Samantha. What does Ross know about murder?
I don't know. I mean,
but again, it's not
mental development. You know, if you got all your wisdom teeth, you're probably like 30 plus.
Yeah, they can get an estimate.
It's not like a test.
Exact.
You scrape off in the tube, and it says this murder victim was 33 years old.
Right. You know what? You know, one of the main reasons I don't like rescue dogs, they don't have an accurate to the day birthday.
Okay, you don't like that, yeah.
No, I'm not saying. Yeah. Look, I'm just saying in my crazy brain, it is something that bothers me. Maggie, I had somebody ask. They keep asking, "How's my mom's dog Maggie doing?" She's fantastic. I love that dog. She gets along with Caesar. Caesar's not doing so good. He's real arthritis-y stiff, but they're best friends. But I hate the fact that she doesn't have a birthday. I hate it. I don't
make one up.
No, that's not her birthday.
That's what Krista did with Lena. And then
I'm not doing that.
She's like, based on when we adopted Lena.
I'm crazy.
Her birthday is probably June 17th. No. And then she would celebrate
like
this.
Just go
with
it, yeah.
This is not accurate. This is for sure not her birthday. It'd be too hard to nail it on the dot.
It's either the birthday.
I know my dog's birthday.
This is all facade.
Yeah, well, because you have a purebred non-shit dog. This is a shit dog, and this dog has no birthday.
Travis is a horrible person, a purebred husky.
Yeah.
Bred in Florida hot.
God, is she beautiful.
Shadow. I don't know her birthday, but when I was sick this morning, she jumped up in bed and cuddled me. What a little sweetie.
I love it. I love dog snuggles.
Roz, you got another story?
Yeah, one more story. Oregon, Josephine County, Oregon. A bunch of health workers were out giving vaccines out on the way back or on the way to another vaccine shot giveaway. They got stuck in the snow, and they had a number of vaccines that were about to expire. So these motherfuckers, tell me if you would do this, Tom. They got out of the car and just started going down the line of cars stuck in the snow saying, "Who wants a vaccine?"
I like that.
That sounds like what Tom would do, yes.
Well, it's better than wasting it, right?
In fact, that sounds like what Tom would do if it were like nothing had gone wrong and he were just had been employed to deliver vaccines to old people.
Well, I would charge.
Well, hey, I got them. Let's try to go single file.
Yeah, yeah. And so now what makes me mad about this, and I don't know this to be true, but I would assume that these people got in trouble for doing this, like you're breaking protocol, whatever, when they should be heralded as geniuses and at least not wasting the vaccine because it's got to be cold. Although you got snow right next to you. I don't know if that, I think it's got to be below freezing. Anyway, they at least didn't waste it. Although, who are the people stuck in their cars that just trust the person they've inferred?
Yeah.
Like, hey, you want this vaccine? And they're like, all right, you lift your sleeve
right,
up.
Right.
Like, who?
My lucky day.
Like, they got scrubs.
I'm going to need to see some credentials here.
By the way, I would totally lift my sleeve up if they had scrubs on. That's all I need. Like, right. Even the pants only. That's just scrub pants. That's enough proof.
I can get this at Goodwill.
That they're professional. I do the math. I look at them and be like, nah, I lift
that's
up my
sleeve. Like, got any mescaline?
Shoot it in there.
I mean, those type of pants are the pants that porn stars wear to Chipotle in L.A. Like, they just wear, yeah. You see the girls, they're wearing scrub pants. I'm like, I think you're an amateur porn star.
Max, or Max.
Wow. Ross. What? You don't know Max, this? No, Ross isn't around this a lot, Ross.
Amazing.
You don't know this. His son, Max, is so large now that he looks exactly like you at 5 years of age. And he's doing stand-up. It's phenomenal.
It's unfortunate.
Yeah, it's phenomenal. He also has kidney stones.
So, Ross, does it say in the story if these people got in trouble or just that was it? They just started giving
up? The story's from the 28th, and I got an update. It got updated on February 2nd, and there is no update about them getting in trouble yet.
All right, good.
I saw the story.
You have to see it's coming, though, right?
Yeah,
they've been hailed as heroes for this.
Have they? Oh, yeah. Okay. Yeah. Listen, it's better than letting it go to waste. But again, I would just imagine there's certain protocol, like, hey, don't give it to someone in their goddamn Astro van. It's like, you know,
using the same fucking needle.
There's a lot of wacky vaccine stories, like the one
I'm
heating
up with my lighter. Like
the one doctor who got 200 vials of the vaccine, but he's a flat earther and went crazy.
Yeah.
He started like smashing them in a dumpster. Like, there's so many crazy stories.
That guy was a flat earther too.
Yeah, he was like, he's flat earth crazy. He's like stomping him place. Yeah. Like, he can't take this.
I hate the internet.
Satanists will never do that.
the internet has just all it really has done is just made me see how many crazy people there are because that's all I never knew. Like in 1996, I didn't know. Like you know, there was the crazy old.
I trusted adults in 1996.
Like, there was a
I did.
Like, you.
I'm serious, man. Like, my parents were smarter than me. I'll never forget the day I realized that my father was fucking dumb. My God.
There was like one.
I'm like, I'm way smarter than this dumb old man.
there was like the crazy old man in your neighborhood that everybody, all the kids knew to stay away because he was a crazy old man. Then there was like, there may have been like, every once in a while you'd see a crazy bum, but that was it. That was like, and now we're exposed to insanity every single day, by multiple times.
Depends which neighborhood you grew up in.
I'm just saying, it's like, not as much as like, now we see insanity. People
I think
every day.
I thought every adult was a dodo when I was growing up.
None of these
motherfuckers know what they're doing.
No, oh, that's true.
They got me so good, they made me believe in them, and I was dependent upon them.
That's true, but I'm talking about mental illness, like severe mental illness, insane. I didn't know how prevalent it was.
Did somebody say mental illness?
Yeah.
When I lived in Pennsylvania, I was a kid. We had this guy that lived like one house up from us, and he came over one day and he's yelling at my dad because he said I was letting the dog shit on his lawn. I was walking my dog, and he said I was letting the dog shit on his lawn. And so my dad's like, "All right, I'll talk to him. I'll make sure he cleans it up next time. Sorry about that." And it wasn't me; it was some other fucking dog wandering the neighborhood. So the next day, he comes over and he's like, he's saying to my dad, "Ross is he's bringing the dog over and making it shit on my lawn." And my dad was like, "You think he can control where that dog is?"
Right.
I was a fucking idiot. Get out of here, old man.
I like that. Hell yeah. I was about to say, I'd like to meet your dad, Ross, but now I'm worried that Ross's dad, your dad's still alive, right?
Correct.
Okay. I'd like to meet your dad. That's it.
Super cool dude. Just sent me a mine and a fucking
kid. That was weird. You stopped the whole show to just say how you want to meet Ross.
Hey, Max, I want to meet your dad.
Yeah. I'm trying. I realize. Okay.
Which is him. He wants to
meet
himself.
Point. He's a goddamn narcissist.
No.
He's also insane. I am not insane, and I'm also the good one.
I'm sorry. Because remember the other day when I asked Mike B if he was married, and they're like, of course, I've been married for 10 years. We've talked about this multiple times.
She's been at so many events.
I thought to myself, like, goddamn, like, get it together. Start remembering about other people's lives.
You can't make a conscious effort. You can't just be like, I got to turn my memory on. I don't think it works like that.
Yeah. I am cognizant about actually remembering details about other people's lives, so I don't look like an asshole narcissist.
Okay, you've known Ross for almost 20 years. You called him Max.
No, that was a regular CTE. mistake. I was going to say, I wish I could meet Ross's dad, because I imagine, just knowing Ross, that Ross's dad
is this where you freak out and wish that you had your dad more? I feel like we're inching closer to him having a full frog ruin the business freak out.
Then I stopped myself because I was like, is Ross's dad still alive? And then I was like, don't ask this question.
Is anyone still alive?
Because he did that to EJ last week, and his dad has passed.
Well, then everybody yells at me.
Dad freak out.
Of course, Ross has mentioned it a million times.
I just want to hug somebody's goddamn dad.
Anyway, that's why I had a weirdo thing happen there. Sorry.
Okay. Here's a rare me in defense of Tom. Tom, go listen to the latest Tots with Ross. I talked to Ken Miller, and when I first started doing comedy, I was always mad at Ken because he would never remember my name. And, you know, I was like, "What? How hard is it to remember a fucking name?" But now that I'm kind of in the same position that Ken was in, like running an open mic, seeing tons of fucking comics come through every week, I apologize to him because I cannot remember anybody's name.
Right.
Like, and with masks now, what anybody looks like? Are you fucking kidding me? No. At this fucking open mic, I run the open mic at the Pullin' Bush on Wednesdays, and I don't say hi to anybody by name. I just hand them the sheet, and then I look at what they sign, and I'm like, "Hey, Joe, what's up?"
Yeah, there it is. See, Ross, I'm glad that it's not only me that, you know, it's too hard.
There's only so many people you can remember.
That's true.
Your brain only has so much input, you know?
Yeah.
That is true. And especially if you don't have pink lasers shooting into them.
Unless you're fucking Jimmy. Jimmy remembers Dirty Jim, 159. That guy remembers people.
He does, but that's normally because he wants to scam them out of money. Like, he remembers them because he saw a mark.
That's an old grifter trick.
Yeah, I remember saw that on Andy Griffith all the time. They go different city to city. They go from Mount Pilot, you know, to the next town over, and then they come in. And,
Oh, God, the grifter episodes were always the best.
They were the best. Well, hey, who's on Tots with Ross this particular week? You just said it's Ken Miller?
Most recent one, Ken Miller. We talk about Ken was the... From Bush through the Clinton years, he was the White House communications guy. So he had some cool stories about that.
Wow.
Shit. The nuclear football and that kind of shit.
Wow.
Good one. And Saturday, go by Bullin' Bush. I'm not going to be there. It's my wife's birthday.
Okay. So happy birthday.
Special guest host Heather Shaw will be there taking care of Shit Sandwich on Saturday.
TikTokers.
Spicy TikTok.
Friend of the show, Chris Crespo. Check out his 420 episode. He had me on to talk about all the shit I'm looking at through the quarantine. And don't forget, the big game is this weekend, and the weekend is performing the halftime show. Fucking do not miss that. And if you happen to have tickets to see the weekend in Orlando, March 28th, 2022, and you want to take me, I will do anything that is not illegal, does not specifically break my marriage vows, and I'm not eating gross stuff.
Oh, are you a
fan? I didn't realize you were such a big weekend fan.
Oh, my God. My daughter, Ross.
Fucking love the weekend.
Maisie, wow. Maisie fucking loves the weekend. Dude, it's her favorite. Like, she's freaking out now because it's the halftime show. And I was explaining. You know what's funny is that little kids don't know. Like, I go, he's the halftime show. She's like, I don't know. What the fuck does that mean?
Right.
Like, well, he's going to do a concert.
In between the football game,
So she asked a great question. She goes, well, why would they stop the game to have him sing? And I go, I think every redneck has asked that in Texas and Florida. I think every redneck asked that. You know what? You're
logical,
right.
Real woman.
I was like, you should keep them separate. You're right. She's like, I don't want to watch football with my weekend, and you don't want to watch the weekend with your football. I'm like, God separate. Damn it.
Play the whole game. No breaks. The whole shit. Time like soccer.
It's got to end.
Yeah, and I hope he plays Save Your Tears in the middle of the fucking Super Bowl and just pisses off every watcher. That'd be great to me.
I love it. It's funny. We had no idea Ross liked the weekend. Well, hey, brother, take care of yourself. Give your wife some happy birthday wishes from us, and we'll see you in a couple weeks, okay?
All right, guys. See you later. Bye.
See you, Ross. Love you, buddy. Be good. That is Ross live from the Ross Palace doing Ross-type things. Oh, my God. Yeah,
man. Double down.
Yeah, you knew what he was doing.
I apologize for my freak out.
No, I liked it.
Why
are you apologizing? We're not a look. The whole
I'm just
idea of
making
today.
Everybody awkward.
No, but that's what makes the show good.
Max forgives you.
If you don't, do that, then we just do a corporate show that everybody hates and it's not fun. Yeah,
I've been recently trying to better myself because I worry that I start seeing similarities between me and my pop-up because he's the only man that really I grew up with the longest, you know, because
well,
my
you grew
dad
up with me. I'd like to think that I made you a man.
I'm just saying in my family that I could see similarities.
Consistent male role figure, right?
Yeah, yeah. Like my stepdad.
I mean, I would like to think that when you came into the radio business, you looked up to me and you're like, who's this Adonis? This guy, I mean, this guy, he's everything he says is hilarious.
He's a radio god.
He's so funny. He does.
He's my radio daddy.
He's the producer. He entertains people. He's doing everything.
Mm.
He's doing everything that nobody else can do.
Anyway, he just, he got, you know, grumpier as time went by and just enjoyed sitting in his garage.
That's what you are becoming.
And just looking out into his yard. Then, you know, some sandhill cranes would come by.
How are your plants?
Oh, yeah, yeah. I'm like, well, I don't want to be an old, grumpy old man that knows nothing about anybody's life and then, you know, becomes a recluse.
Ooh, you got a lot of work to do, buddy.
Well, that's what I'm trying.
You don't even know how to spell my daughter's name.
Like, you can't spell my name. He writes me a check every month.
Now I'll remember that Ross has a dad. that's a one step forward.
Tell me something. Let's just get a couple of updates out of the way before we do take our second break. How is the wooden chandelier coming along?
Oh, God.
Oh, let me tell you. No respect. No respect. Wife comes home with two by-fours. She's making a fucking wooden chandelier. I said, hey, what are we living, a fucking teepee? No respect.
I hate you.
That's just off.
I hate using my front door, and ever since I got a precision door, garage door,
through the window.
I know I only go through my garage and the garage door, and what? That's
What if he becomes Rodney Dangerfield?
It's happening.
And then this goddamn wooden chandelier is on two sawhorses, and it's impeding my path, and I have to walk sideways past.
So I have to do that to get past the grift truck in my garage because it takes up my entire garage.
Oh, wooden chandelier on top of grift truck, blow it up.
Yes, please.
And
so when does it get mounted?
I don't know. It's just like there's this whole process.
How big is it?
I can mount it on a spike.
Yes. That was the perfect comment at absolutely the wrong time. Oh, that was good. Look at what you did. Just go ahead and look at what you
did.
Don't
bring up the spike.
Look what you did to him. Look how ready he is now. It's mad.
It's like 4 foot or 5 foot by 1 foot box. Anyway, it's too big. I'm like, what? How are we going to secure it? So she's like, don't get the drywall anchors because you always fuck that up. That's the correct.
Oh, tapcons. You're getting the tapcons?
No, it's because it's dry. Anyway, it's the whole thing. It is going to fall out of the wall.
Oh, my God.
I'm like, why are we doing it? Just leave it. It's got a fan.
Why do you buy a light? That's what most people do.
Yeah.
I know.
They got the, okay.
They don't have the exact, I don't know
if you know
what
this.
What does she want?
But you can get really intricate, made of metal. They have this material. I think it's like almost 100 times stronger than wood. This is a new thing. No, I swear to God, this is a fucking new thing. They have a new material. It's stronger than wood, can be lighter at times, and it's fucking shiny, reflects the light. Mm. It's amazing.
Yeah. Well, believe me, I've learned not to.
Your wife would kill me with my sarcasm.
She'd
punch me right in right in my midget face.
I've learned, don't ask, don't tell.
I just
squeeze by it, and it'll never go up, and it'll slowly just be pushed over into the other garbage. And then,
I have bought so many light fixtures over the past year in my new house. I could have helped her.
Instead of
building one.
No, she wants to build it.
No, it's very specific. Listen, if you want to talk about the...
No, I don't.
Who wants to talk about it? Give her a call.
The name of the band is Antagonizers ATL. The name of the song is Marching On. It's punk rock.
All right.
We're going to do a little of this and be back. 1-844-TOM, the letter M-D-A-N. Show at TomandAnn.com for emails. We'll be back. I don't like cold weather.
Mm.
In fact, I hate it.
Yep.
With all my heart. And I've never been happier to have heat that works without smelling like you're starting up a two-stroke dirt bike. Because I got preventative maintenance from American Air and Heat, and it's that sweet family-friendly service, and I do the preventative maintenance. And you owe it to yourself to do it. Because, you know, this is one of the first times we actually had to use our damn heat.
I hate it. And you want to make sure you do that once a year just so you don't have any problems down the road. Mm-hmm. The worst is having your AC, not work at the right time. And then, you know.
True story.
They'll come out.
Well, when we bought that house bank owned, right?
Yeah.
They had used whoever to do the AC and the wires for cooling and the wires for heating. And apparently this is like a really common thing, were reversed. So when our air was originally, you know, our air was working fine for the first time we owned the house. But when we went to put on the heat, it would kick on the air at the same time and both would run at the same time.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Basically doubling our power bill, ruining everything that we have in our house. That's why you owe it to the things that you, your house, the things that you have purchased, to go with somebody who's going to actually do the job and do it correctly. Because, man, we had that for a year and didn't know it was doing that.
The best thing I ever did was get a complete new system with all new ducts in my house from American Air and Heat. Not only am I saving a bunch of money because it's so much more efficient, the new system, but my house cools better because I only had one return in, prior to this. It was by my couch, and I think a lot of people, I had the duct system from the original house, and now, of course, they figured out and they use technology in American Air and Heat. When, if they redo your whole system, they'll redo the duct, so every room in your house...
They just run it the most efficient to cool that place the way it's supposed to be cooled.
If every room in your house doesn't have a return in the ceiling, you're doing it wrong. It's trapping the heat in there. So, it's just, it, yeah, it's blowing cold air, but the hot air is just sitting on the ceiling. Ceiling heat, you know, so it's hard for the system to be efficient. And with the well, they'll come in and do a full redesign of your complete system, new ducts.
Yeah, just get a quote, man. Yeah, I mean, what's, you know,
they finance, they'll finance it all if you want to do that. But I'm telling you, you'll save money. And
all we ask is just
better.
Maybe consider them, you know, give them a call and see what they have to offer. We've had plenty of listeners have gotten system. I know Tactical got a system, got some work done. I know that I know people in Andrea's family have gotten some work done. All of our families have gotten work done, but in a state where it gets disgustingly hot, you know, go with somebody who's tried and true.
Just do the math. Get the quote for a new system. Look how much your money you're spending on repairing your old system or your energy bill. It's insane. Anyway, it's AmericanAirAndHeat.com.
Like a little synth poppy action.
Oh.
No, is it playing the Ross thing?
Yeah, yeah.
Did I do it?
Yeah,
that's fine. Okay. Yeah, it fit the music. I didn't even notice. I was like, yeah, it works.
Welcome.
Yes!
Welcome
good.
Hey!
That's why I leave it up to you.
That's
Welcome. This is getting bad.
Drink a little more of that.
By the way, guys, he has a mango Sprite Mike's mix. Hard Lemonade in front of him. He has had no sips of it. Did you drink all that Sprite you made?
Yeah, I drank it all.
Yeah, that's your problem. There it is.
Just a little bit.
No, you can't do that. You're alcoholic. So am I. Why? I'm not drinking. I just said alcoholic.
I thought it was supposed to make my hands and my body work better, right?
That's no. Like, uh-oh. Somebody's calling.
Oh.
Hello?
Hey.
Hi there.
Hey, this is BDM Nick. How are you?
Hi, BDM Nick. It's Dan from Tom and Dan. I'm Dan. I'm the D part. What's up?
Tom.
That's Tom. He's the T part.
What up, Big D?
What's going on? No, not a Big D. I'm a little D. I'm 5'2". I'm losing weight, though. I look good. I'm in the 150s now, which is nice. And like, I'm trying to ease down. I'm trying to, I'm back at 31 days in a row, man.
What's going on?
Good for you guys, man. Well, hey, I just wanted to call in real quick and let you guys know that if I lose my job, I did it for you guys.
Oh, no. Don't blame us.
Do you shoot up the place? Don't do that. Don't shoot up the place.
Nah, man. I'm a project manager for an HCM firm, and I work for...
Hold on one second. Hey, thanks for calling A Mediocre Time. Who's this?
This is Doug.
Hi, Doug. You're on the line right now with... what was your name again, sir?
Nick.
My name is
Nick.
Doug.
Okay, Doug, you're talking to Nick right now. Nick, tell Doug your story, please.
What up, Doug? Yo, so Doug, I lose my job. I did it for Tom and Dan. I'm a project manager of a small firm, and I had an employee reach out to me to ensure his address had been updated. He recently moved from, I don't know, we'll say Virginia, down into Winter Park, Florida. So I updated his address, and then at the bottom of my professional email, I said, hey, man, if you like tacos, check out Gringo's Locos and buy a double D. Or if you like comedy podcasts, don't forget to reach out and check out A Corporate Time with Tom and Dan. So
we'll
see what an executive thinks about that.
Yeah, Doug, what do you think about Nick's idea?
It's very interesting. But I really wanted to call about
the R-words.
Did a very good.
Man, I need to get on Doug's level.
Good Lord.
Seth Petrozelli.
Uh-huh.
Oh.
That's who I really wanted to call about.
Uh-oh. Oh, no. You hear this, Nick? We got one.
Come on. We was on Joe Rogan, show number 1603 for over a minute. He's got complete bragging rights. Seth Rogen.
Oh, Doug. You're my new favorite.
They're all gone.
Mike B, move aside. Yeah, yeah.
Wow.
What'd you think of Nick and Doug show?
Yeah, it was good.
I'm drunk now. I said the Nick and... That's what I said.
Yeah.
Because I'm drunk now.
We did hear about
Fun
that.
Fun Friday.
Yeah, I know.
And we will have Seth back in to talk about it.
What happened to Seth?
Rogan finally talked to him?
No. He just mentioned.
No, that's never going to happen.
Gotcha.
Maybe that's why Seth sat down.
What if that's why he sat? He rode by my house, right, on his bikes. And me and my wife were outside having a, we do this new thing on Wednesdays. We do a wine down Wednesday where we sit outside and we drink wine and we talk shit about you guys. So I'm out there drinking wine, talking shit about you guys, smoking weed. And I see... two people ride by on a bike, and Andrea goes, "That's Seth."
Oh, yeah, he told me about that.
Yeah, and I go, "No, it's not." And she goes, "Yeah, that's Seth and his girlfriend." And I go, Seth, I scream. Nobody does anything. I'm like, "Seth!" And then I see him turn around, but I can't see it's him. But then I got distracted because I just started looking at his girlfriend's yoga pants.
Apparently.
I was trying to look at the, I wanted to see if they're in there.
Imagine if you went back in time and you told someone 20 years ago that you'd be, someone would be super excited that Joe Rogan talked about you.
You mean the guy from News Radio?
There's a lot of things.
Hold on, we got another.
It's Nick again.
Nick, what say you to the BDM universe?
No.
I don't think it picked up.
Hang up on it.
Anyway, yeah, I did see on the BDM page people were like, Joe Rogan talked about Seth and this mark. I didn't go and listen to it, but apparently I think he was talking about the Kimbo fight.
I believe that's what they mentioned, yeah.
And then a bunch of people were reaching out to Seth. But I never saw Seth make a comment. Next time he comes back on the show.
You know who's better than Joe Rogan and Seth Petruzzelli? Seth Rogan.
Yeah.
That's what he said. Yeah, remember that drunk guy, Doug?
Yeah, that's what he yelled.
But it's a weird thing because when you get mentioned on a super popular podcast, it's kind of like having a viral video, right? It's exciting for no reason.
It doesn't do you anything. We've been mentioned on BurtCast, unfortunately, while he was talking to Brian Callen, and then he's like, "Hey."
Well, he's mentioned you guys before.
Anytime you're in Orlando, you need to definitely check out Tom. Check out Tom and Dan.
He did it on...
Most comedians talk like that.
Yeah, and then so those one-off mentions, they can, I guess...
It can work, because I listened to a Bert Kreischer episode, and he had a group of comedians that were on that do a show, and now I listen to their podcast. I don't even listen to his anymore.
True, but the thing is, like...
I only listen to Ross's show and... old episodes of BYOCB. The early ones.
The
first five episodes.
Yeah, with Adam.
In the podcasting community, of course, like, what if you got 100 extra listeners? Great! But it's not going to change your life. Also, with Seth, now someone mentioned Seth and talking about the story, happened.
It's also not that far off for him, for Rogan to talk about that, because it's... So he's talking about
fighting,
UFC.
Yeah. So it's like, it doesn't really move the needle, although, be it exciting... No good could really, or at least life-changing good,
that's
could come
how,
it's just like,
I mean, that's kind of how I feel about TikTok. I know a lot of people mm-hmm. that have millions of people that follow them on TikTok.
Heather Shaw talked about it. Didn't really do anything for
Heather
her.
Shaw. Well, she's one of the bigger ones. I probably know and follow. I talked to her on TikTok. I'm active on TikTok only to observe. I don't post shit for shit. But then there's another buddy of ours that you and I both know. He works in the film industry. You know who I'm talking about. I'm not going to say his name, but he's huge on TikTok. He's been talking to superstars.
Ron Jeremy.
No, it's not Ron Jeremy. And this guy, I think he makes a little money from it, but I don't know if he's able to legitimately harness all of the power it has. I wish he could, because he's a great dude.
You need some sort of product or something to funnel that notoriety to be able to make it worth it or even move the needle. But anyway, yeah. Next time Seth comes in, we're going to make fun of him about it.
We always making fun of
Seth.
Let's
dump him out.
I think I may have thrown away my dump him out sheet.
What?
Just kidding, I got it. Dump him out.
We got too many topics on the list today. It's the end of the motherfucking show. So come on, baby, let's dump them out and play. I want to see your topics. Ooh, I want to also see your bottom mix.
Dump them out, brought to you by SecuredRoofingAndRestoration.com. Get a free estimate and get a prize from us. That's all you have to do.
What kind of prize?
We'll send you a straw hat right now. That's that's the new gift.
Straw hats.
The new gift.
Yeah, yeah.
You know, they make hats now out of like synthetic materials.
I have. Yeah, like, straw.
It lasts a long. Oh,
have you heard of three pigs?
I heard of three pigs. I'm one of the pigs.
Yeah, brick hats.
I don't know if you know this. Can't get through that. You're looking at sticks here.
Oh, you're pig sticks.
Yeah, I'm pig sticks.
Babe, I'm leaving. Must be on my way.
Yes. God, I love sticks.
So let's do this one first, just because it has a YouTube video attached to it. So my new thing is I get super high, and
that's not new.
I go out and I watch YouTube in my hot tub, and because it's cold outside,
yeah.
And I just sit there and I watch mindless YouTube because I've realized that
you're your kids now.
I'm driving.
Watch your Minecraft videos.
Yeah, but I'm also I was driving myself insane by trying. I at the beginning of the year I convinced myself that I can become ultra efficient man and every waking moment be working on solving a problem.
Like, wow.
And
every waking moment?
Yeah,
like I have solving the world's problems or just our problems?
Yeah, just like Tom problems.
Yeah, whatever problem I have, business problem.
Or issues.
Personal problem.
I don't seem to have socks on right now.
That's a problem.
I'm like, I'm gonna go put some socks on.
I was just like,
I'm a problem solver.
I'm not gonna waste any time. I'm not gonna waste my life. I'm not gonna watch mindless.
Well, then you'd have to just not talk.
Juan, our Twitch manager in the Twitch chat room, twitch.tv/TomAndDanLive, shots fired, says, you're becoming just like Ross.
Then I decided that I do need some time where I think about nothing and I watch mindless nothing because without that, I was becoming irritable and
dickhead.
And becoming insane because I'm like, I cannot just think 100% of the time and solve problems. I have to do nothing at certain points.
I can't solve all the world's problems.
I'm not solving anything, by the way. It didn't help me at all. Anyway,
blissfully numb is nice.
So I'm sitting in the hot tub watching, and then Crystal comes out.
Yeah.
And then she's in the hot tub. And then
with them floating right on the top.
I became obsessed with survival YouTube.
What is that?
It's like I call them survival nerds, who basically.
Oh, look at this. My flint's dry. Ah, made a fire.
They make challenges. Like, and this one guy, he builds like a tiny little coffin size, wooden with insulation, camper that he drags behind a snowmobile. And then he goes into the middle of the Arctic somewhere.
And he sleeps in insulated coffin.
And he sleeps inside this
fucking stupid,
and he uses the campfire to heat his thing, and it's just some nerd.
If I found his coffin in the wilderness and he was sound asleep inside of it, I would set it on fire and burn him alive in it.
So, and then it just jumps to the random videos,
just like the Satanists.
And then it started the videos, and you guys are probably familiar with these videos of they're like native to
Middle
their
Eastern
country.
Mud people building crazy pools.
Yes.
Yeah.
No, I don't know where.
I know that's disrespectful to call them Middle Eastern mud people. You know what? I'd like to redact that.
South America? I don't know where it is. Is it
almost
in
like
India?
Thai.
Thailand?
Yeah.
Like Thailand? But anyway,
they're brown people that they are really good at mud engineering.
The
mud engineers.
And they dig with just one tool,
very rudimentary
a spade.
Tools.
Yeah, it's like a stick.
And then the ground is some sort of clay where they can sculpt it into a mansion and the pool. And
but
put
what
dirty
do they
water.
Do with all of these clay mansions? Yeah. Is this like the Italy where I can buy a clay mansion for $1
and they don't
and move into it? I'll do it.
And they don't talk. And by the way, on the bottom it says
get a lot more work done. There's, shut the fuck up.
There's no audio. It's just these guys, and all of them are.
It's all time lapse,
and they're all wearing one pair of light brown
Old Navy shorts. yeah. Wear one pair of light brown Old Navy shorts.
So we've all seen those, but now this
four-way stretch
that played, and we were watching that. Then it skipped to this other one, which was a woman doing it by herself, and the title.
But that takes 15 times as long.
And I'm not joking. The title, and everybody look this up, is just Woman Builder, right? That's it. And it's the same.
That was the precursor to Bob the Builder.
Now it looks like the same area, and like the nature looks the same, and it's the same clay. So whatever, so she has a stick India. With an I don't know where it is, and then she goes out there, and there's a particular episode. Now she builds a bunch of things. One she builds like swimming pool with a house. By the way, like I'm watching, and she's just like yak yak, like she gets up there totally calm, and then this is nothing.
How long does it take? I want real time.
It's multiple days, because I put two and two together how they film it. They must just take a span of the same day, so the lighting's the same, and then they just do over multiple days, and then time lapse it. Now, also, I think
they're just really fast.
There's a bit of bullshit going on, because I'm like, for sure they film her doing it, like, you know, when she's digging the pool with the spade, right? Like, they film her for about 2 minutes digging crazy, and then they
let the workers do it.
Yes, and then I'm sure she takes a break, and then they dig it out more, and then she gets back in, and then does, like, I don't think she does, and by the way, when she fills the pool one jug at a time, give me a break, like, they bring in a hose or some shit. No camera
guy. Do you want me to play some of this, or, like, I got them.
So, now, everybody's seen this, but this is where it takes a weird, creepy turn, and where my wife has this theory with this particular clip that could be true, and I'll let you guys decide by playing it. So, in this particular clip of Woman Builder, she builds an underground mansion. It's called, like, Woman Builder Underground Mansion, right? And basically, she builds a house.
Yeah, it says, build the most beautiful bath pool for underground mansion in the jungle by Woman Builder.
Yeah, so, and what it is
sounds like you wrote the title.
Yeah, it really does.
It's bizarre. I don't know what.
Are you sure you're just not trying to get more views for your underground slaves that build these castles?
By the way, how many views total does this have?
2 million.
Yeah, so 2 million total views. So basically, in this clip, she's
a relatively newer video,
And by the way, like, they show, like, she builds the clay bed, and then she, like, she lays down on it, and then they time
it.
Oh,
so comfy.
Yeah, it was like,
just like a Casper.
I also screamed out, my God, I've seen this woman do more work than I've ever done in my entire life. Yeah. Like, it's insane.
Yeah, but has she delivered more smiles than you?
Yes. 2 million smiles.
I'm watching this.
I don't know about 2 million.
Yeah, I'm frowning.
So...
And some of those guys are jacking off.
Okay, so this ties perfectly into this. So in the underground...
Or unties.
In the underground mansion episode of Woman Builder, she decides to build a...
bathhouse.
Elaborate bath, like bathtub, in her mansion, which is just a hole where she like pretended to have like a
all bathtubs,
a king's throne.
Theoretically, are just holes.
And so she starts digging crazy with her spade, and then she carves out, I think this person's an artist, by the way, like a sculptor. Like,
looks like it.
So she sculpts out an ornate bathtub.
I mean, at her very least, she's made a few cakes.
Yeah. And with flower designs behind it, where she paints by the way, like crushing berries and straw up with her feet, and with a little bit of
traditional
water.
Traditional pigments.
She's making paint, and like...
that's how you painted for Big Fat Norm.
Right.
So, and she makes this crazy ornate bathtub with flower designs, and she fills it one pot at a time.
Okay. Like, RPenny787 says, get to the question, my God, Tom.
Okay. So, then... And you could play right now. Okay. After she makes the bathtub, she decides to take a bath, right? So she lights all the candles, gets it in the...
Lighting her smudge pot.
Yeah. She has a bunch of pots in there.
Oh, my God,
mansion.
It's Ross. Oh, my God, I'm back to Ross. Hold on. I'll go back to...
So... And she puts the little tiny candles in the
bathroom. One good monsoon, and this is a mud bog.
Yeah. I don't know how long it lasts.
Did she die inside it?
It's all for this YouTube. It's not real. It's just for this.
It's a movie set.
No. She really does this.
I know.
I'm just saying, it's no one's living in this stupid
thing. She's filling up the. Do they tear these down?
I have no idea. I'm fascinated with all this.
That's where the snakes take over. It's Indiana Jones.
So she's filling the bathtub one pot at a time, right?
It looks like
up and down the stairs.
It looks like an Assassin's Creed crypt. And by the way, I don't want to take a bath in that mud water.
So
that ain't cleaning shit.
So now she gets the flowers, and then she gives the petals of the flowers and sprinkles it in.
This is very romantic.
By the way, dirty brown water. And,
that's how you get a yeast infection.
Okay, then, she's... Okay, hold on a second.
So... We watched this part, and
I'm surprised your wife sat and watched this with you.
I'm surprised you're married.
and so in this particular part, because we were joking around the entire time, but my God, this woman is the hardest working woman I've ever seen in my entire person I've ever seen. And the fact that she built this damn thing by hand,
very impressive.
Even if it was partially faked, which I assume it was, the fact that she, I mean, even the time lapse that she did do.
Be proud.
I'm just like, my God.
Well done.
And Crystal has this theory, and I'll let you guys decide, that the people that were filming this for this YouTube channel, right, convinced this lady through either money or like pressured her to, at the end of the mansion bathtub carving,
should I just... Can I air this?
Yeah, because it's all, I mean, there's no nudity at all. Look at her face, because Crystal's like, oh my God, they forced her to get in there. Look how disgusted she is with herself.
No.
And look how angry she is and mad that...
I'm just talking about me in this hot tub. I'm doing exactly what she did, and I'm angry for sitting in this... brown water with my husband.
Because she's like, why? She's like, for sure, the cameraman asked her, like, disrobe and get in the bathtub and add some sort of sexy element. And
you want to pull out your Indian tits?
Crystal was like, this woman's obviously a artist. She's a sculptor.
She's a builder. It's literally called a woman builder.
Obviously, this woman was an Indian surgeon who was forced at gunpoint to disrobe and get in a mud bath.
So watch, and you guys can decide if she likes what she's doing right now just by her facial expressions.
I'll be able to tell you within three notes.
Yeah. So,
oh Lord.
And you guys decide if she's being forced to do this by what Crystal described as
slavery.
White corporate cameraman, YouTube cameraman. So. Look at her eye. Look at her disgust in her face and how miserable she is doing this.
I mean, I don't see disgust. I mean, disgust is a pretty...
I think she's just a hard woman that's like, I'm taking a bath.
Well,
like, she doesn't... No,
she's not taking a bath to relax. She's taking a bath for purpose.
Correct.
But
she sweated her ass off building this shit.
Yeah, but she's not really taking a bath. Like, it's dirty swamp water that she poured in there, brown. And anyway, I told Crystal that she may be right, but she may be looking too much into it.
I think she's looking a little too much into it. Also, like, I don't know how this is filmed, but it's all very much still shots as if she sets up her own camera, but I don't
know. Yeah, that's what I'm thinking.
Does she do this herself?
I think so.
I think she does too.
I don't think there's a camera crew, or there'd be movement in your shot, so that should make your wife feel better.
And I haven't seen any moving cameras.
I think Sam nailed it. As a woman, Sam would, I think, know.
She's fucking tired, man. She just wants to wash her face and her rose petals.
You're also an independent lady. I don't think she has
a
crew.
It's a dirty mud bath.
Not either.
I don't think she has a crew.
No. No, it's her by herself?
And I'm looking at some of her other videos, and it's all, like, still cameras.
You'd have better shots if you had a crew.
So did she decide at the end she was going to, because in...
Demonstrate the bath.
When it looks like she framed it up.
That's the thing is, like... You're almost kind of being sexist and saying, like, look, she looks miserable because what? She's not a model, like, caressing her hair in the fucking bath. She's literally utilizing it as a bath.
Her eyes.
She's fucking tired.
She's got mud water in her eyes.
I know what you mean about her eyes darting, but.
She was like, oh, God, I'm going to have to do this. Like,
that doesn't mean the same thing for you or Crystal that it may mean for her. Because even culturally, I think that there are different ways that you can look at people, and you may not even understand the emotion that they're even exuding at that moment,
you
know?
Yeah, yeah, yeah. Listen, it's...
I do feel like your wife, though, felt that feeling and then projected it onto this woman, absolutely. I think she feels sorry for her. But I think she did this on her own.
Okay, all right.
Because I don't see any Zooms.
Right.
Where are the Zooms? Even with a crew, you'd Zoom. You'd slowly...
Not even Zoom, just, like, moving, like, at all.
You would slowly move that shot. Like, that's a stagnant shot. All of these shots are shots it looks like she set up. Weird.
Yeah.
Listen, if you watch it yourself, Woman Builder Mansion Underground.
Yeah, tell us what you think.
It's
very impressive.
It's insane.
Get rid of this lady here. Too many buttons. Too many buttons.
What else?
That is let me get rid of dumb magic. Sorry. Okay, there we go.
What else do we want to talk about?
Do you want to get into the prop bets first, or do you want to jump around to some other subjects?
We'll do the prop bets last.
Okay, so you got Tomb of the Unknown Soldier, whatever that is.
Okay, so Crystal told me, she's like, they're... And I didn't know this, but in the Tomb of the Unknown Soldier in D.C., that there is a guard that stands there 24 hours a day, every day.
It's pretty cool.
And he just stands there, right? And then it's been going on for, I don't know how, I think since the inception of it. And so the person just stands there at guard as like a tribute, but it's a human, and they literally never, like, you know, and apparently me and Butler looked up that they do it in shifts of hour shifts, and there's a bunch of volunteers that just stand there for an hour. And I was like, what if it rains? Do they use an umbrella or someone help them out, or they just stand there in the rain? And I got very upset if they just stood there in the rain. That's it.
Do they just stand in the rain?
I don't know. I had. There's no way for me to find that information out.
So you're saying you don't like, as an American,
Costanza.
You do not like that.
Oh, I don't like the fact that no one, like, they can't use an umbrella or whatever. I assume that it's probably like some, like, military respect that they just stand through, like the guards at the Buckingham Palace, you know, they're not allowed to do anything.
Well, they stand in a little hut.
I agree, but I think you're onto something. I think there should be a covering.
Let them use an umbrella. Yeah. Stand there.
Look, we have money. Build him a little stand. Yeah, like if the Brits have a stand, you know, then you put him under a stand. Yeah. At least he didn't have to get wet. I agree with that.
I just got angry at them.
Serving for the country, right? He's volunteering.
I think, yeah.
He was an active service member, right? Thank you for your service.
It's volunteers.
That's a big deal, right? And now we got a guy, he's volunteering to do it outside of the service he already gave the country. I say, yeah, you build him a goddamn thing over there.
Yeah. I just got angry at the fact
that, I agree with you,
that he probably just does stand in the rain because that's a, you know.
Now, aesthetically, I understand that they may not want a structure to break the skyline or something. Maybe it looks cool. Maybe there's a flame or, like, I don't know. There may be like other things. But I think they can build him a little thing to keep him dry.
Or, if it does rain, do, like, the general public, like, go over there and get an umbrella? Like, someone who lives down the street, like, oh, it's raining, I'm going to go get an umbrella, and well, I mean, over the guard of the unknown soldier.
You can do that
soldier.
If you want to go viral. You give you give an umbrella to Tommy or Max, you have them walk over there, open it slowly as you're filming, and place it over the man, and then you film it, and you go, he did this without me even saying anything. My God! And then you put
as if my six-year-old would ever come up with the idea.
But, oh, you fabricated the whole... Oh, it's all fake. It doesn't matter.
I found the answer. What happens in bad weather?
All right.
They get wet. The tomb is always guarded. If it is too cold or raining, the guards change to black leather gloves.
Oh, you're
gloves
doing it too.
From white gloves, and the weapons inspection does not take place. Other than that, it is the walking the mat as normal, so they do not use an umbrella.
God damn it.
And we read they rotate every hour, and then certain times of the year, it's every half hour.
Yeah, right. The changing of the guard. And an hour
and Twisted Movie says these guards are all seasoned soldiers. Rain doesn't mean shit. That's not what it's about. We understand these guys are tough.
Right.
They've dedicated themselves to military service.
But at this point...
We're saying
an umbrella.
Well, we're saying
a raincoat.
No, we're doing the opposite. We're saying you have earned the right to have a fucking shelter because you dedicated yourself to work your way up to the highest tier of basically like American human sacrifice, right? So you have earned a shelter. I agree with that.
And if you're in Vietnam and you got to sleep back to back with your shrimp and friend and big old fat rain, like, guess what? It's going to be some shit. You're in war. hard.
Yeah,
it's
that's
hard.
Different.
But if you're volunteering to do this thing that's really just like no one's attacking the tomb of the unknown soldier. There's no real reason for a guard there, right? Like I guess maybe you don't want anybody to vandalize it or something. But I mean, like
they wouldn't. I don't think.
I mean, even
well,
then,
this day and age, they would. But the guard is absolutely needed. Never mind.
Well, I'm just saying, throw the guy an umbrella.
We have some questions from the Twitch chat room, twitch.tv/TomandanLive. The most important question I have vetted from Ghost of Minute Bull says, does anyone refer to condoms as raincoats or Jimmy hats anymore?
No.
Nobody even refers to condoms except for Butler.
I don't think people even wear condoms anymore.
Except for Butler.
It's got to be a better technology, right?
My God, there has to be.
One of the things
have to deal with garbage birth control. Give guys something else other than just condoms. There's got to be something else.
Garbage birth control sounds terrible.
It's all garbage.
My wife, when she makes me wear a condom, I cut the top off so the head of my dick comes
out. Right. More comfortable that way.
The sensitive part. My God, it feels good, but it's weird. It makes my dick look like a lollipop.
It's like a sleeve.
Yeah, squeezes the center down.
They got skins now, which is a super thin condom.
Skins? Oh, God.
No.
So,
it's new Trojan skins with a Z.
It is, actually.
God, it'll kill me. You know what? Flush those down the toilet. Skins with a Z? Don't
Love
do
it.
That, Trojan. You're better than that.
They're
with
not.
A Z?
They're not better than that.
So, did you hear about Marilyn Manson this week out?
Yeah, he's like a big satanic rapist or something? Like, I don't know what.
So
that's pretty accurate.
Okay,
he's got some allegations.
So, they're like you read the stories and allegedly all these horrible things that the guy, has been portrayed as a horrible monster, right? If you read some accounts from ex girlfriends and like the abuse,
Rachel Evan Wood,
yeah, it's
surprise.
Like and it's beyond even like it's like mental, it's like R. Kelly shit.
Yeah, what did he do?
He was like grooming her since she was a teenager,
but like
and, like.
I didn't read like any of it, so I don't really know. Like, I was just like, oh, okay, that fits the mold.
Like,
all right.
Basically...
Gaslighting.
Body shaming her to have eating disorders.
Borderline rape shit, some
like,
of that.
Make her, all weird, like,
power
over the top,
shit.
Crazy...
Yeah, it's power shit.
Fucked up, weird power
horrible shit that allegedly this person did. And then there's other accounts... from other women.
Which is very on brand with his best friend, Johnny Depp, who just fought a libel case that he lost, by the way.
Yeah, he did.
Now,
he's a wife beater.
Bad.
If we're going to look at the good in this, follow me here. Follow me. Hold on.
Yeah, I'm walking with
you. I'm not
I'm not going to tell people I'm
hear
following
me out.
You. I just happen to be walking around you.
We're in the same vicinity.
I'm holding hands with you. jumping off a cliff.
Not following, walking with.
Yes.
The fact that he is, in fact, seemingly a horrible piece of shit, right?
Better for his brand?
Okay, that's what I'm saying. Okay, so could you make the argument that this somehow enhances this character and his music because he actually
is
a piece of shit, horrible... Like,
here's the thing that I will combat that with. A couple different things. Other artists who are also pieces of shit have also sang songs that basically are telling on themselves on what pieces of shit they are. It's just been decoded now, essentially. Like, you're really a terrible human being.
Louis C.K. was the greatest of that. You know, you do stand-up for years basically outlining everything you
Do. Yeah,
R. Kelly, the lead singer Brand New, like a lot of different people.
Of course.
And then also the fact that your own record label literally just dropped you because they believe that shit. So then it's not good for your brand.
No. I know. No. I'm not saying financially.
Yeah, I know what you mean.
I'm not saying this is a horrible business.
You're saying like his fanatics are like, yes.
No. Not even that.
Trent Reznor says you're fucking weird.
Exactly.
You're weird.
No. Tom is saying if you're checking the box of weirdos,
is it
satanic,
on brand?
Satanic, dark, fucked up music guy.
Yes. Yeah.
I mean,
now business wise, even his own fans probably are dislike this. Or
no,
like
I've seen him defending him.
Are they? Yeah. I saw the opposite the other day on a thread, man. I saw him just eating shit.
But I'm saying back when I remember when Marilyn Manson was the most popular, and the rumor back then was the guy was actually just like some nerd that wasn't all this is all a character.
He was.
I was disappointed because I was like, oh God, it's all an act.
You know,
and now that he's a piece of shit.
Thing too,
I'm like,
right? When you were in high school, you guys had like goths and shit, right? In your high school, but they were most of them were all fucking nerds.
I know. Yeah, yeah.
Well, they were the people that didn't fit into the cliques.
Right.
That were,
but they weren't
were
like
pop,
evil
were
or
popular.
Satanic,
no,
I know.
Like,
right?
Yeah,
of course. Of course they're not, because it's all just a fucking thing. I'm just saying that this adds a little. I mean, if you're on a spectrum towards good and evil, this puts you towards the evil, right? Which your brand is evil, the fucking beautiful people, the titties. You know what I'm saying? He's a weirdo piece of shit. I'm like, oh, there it is.
There
it
could,
is, actually.
No, there could be something to that, because they're...
It's not good, bad. I'm just saying it's...
No, I agree with you, because, like, Ghost of Manute Bull, I read his funny comment last time. Was it him? No, it was somebody else here. Who said it this time? Blue BMX says, much like many of the gothic niche genre, witch house ended up killing themselves, or when rappers get shot in gang violence.
Hmm.
Yeah, I see what you're saying. It's okay, I've done music where I've glorified rape. I've glorified murder. I've talked about how I want to watch the world burn, or I want to turn you upside down. I want to mind control you and fucking mind fuck you.
Yeah, but he's denying all of it.
I understand that, but of course you are. Because it starts to get criminal.
Did the character caught? Okay, but like Tupac. Tupac was a
poet,
he was in the arts,
actor,
and a dancer,
ballet dancer,
model.
He started as a backup dancer for the fucking
Digital Underground.
Yeah, yeah, and then like the hardcore gangster.
When I think Tupac, I go writer.
Yeah,
he's like a writer.
Yeah.
So and then I remember hearing that too at the popularity of Tupac. You know, like
Rosin Concrete.
Where like people were debating whether he was actually a hardcore gangster, or like, you know, there's all this like, oh, he was
they've
a dancer.
They've always done that. They've done that with everybody.
But then he gets shot, and you know,
start hanging around those folks, shit's gonna happen.
But you could make the argument that it
did elevate
on
it
the
did.
Spectrum of gangster
it,
and
no,
an artist nerd, or like a being in love with the arts is like ticked up towards gangster.
I honestly think there's no way to not.
I mean, he got shot. He didn't actually go out shooting people or anything.
But it did
elevate his level of
street
cred.
Yeah, for sure.
I mean, like,
if he died in a bungee jumping accident, it would be there.
Yeah,
it goes towards the back of the
town. It'd be like, well, how did he die? Well, he was actually, he went in to get facial, you know, he's getting some liposuction and died on the it ain't going to work the same.
My only argument, when we'll move on, is that this, you know, seemingly that Marilyn Manson is a like evil piece of shit, you know, ticks him up towards the evil character that he's portrayed for all these years.
Here's what I'll say. I'd like to see less of this. I know that as a middle-aged, I guess, slightly middle-aged man in America, I just would like to see less of my musical people, you know. I'm not going to wing the phrase heroes around, because I would like to see these people that I enjoy their music and their acting and their songs and their creativity. I'd like to see them treat each other and other people with more respect and not fucking do this type of stuff.
Do you think if Marilyn Manson never got famous that this would have happened anyway?
Probably not.
No.
Because your power and influence there, then you start manipulating that. And
I do believe it changes.
You know, because if you're just fucking Marilyn Manson, the accountant.
Brian, no whatever his name is.
No one's
Warner,
Brian Warner, the accountant. No one's going to stick around for your years of physical and mental abuse.
That's not true.
You're right, though.
Because that fucking happens every day.
So then
but he definitely had more access to people.
It must have been always inside him.
Yes, he's just a shitty person that got famous and had money.
And so I wonder.
That.
If it would have
Phoebe Bridgers, who's actually the music artist that's going to be on SNL this week, she came out and said she went to Marilyn Manson's house when she was a teenager. I don't know under what circumstances, but that she was introduced to a room called the Rape Room. You know, when you name a room in your house the Rape Room.
That was Tom's original name for his burger joint that he wanted to open.
Oh.
Like, right around 2015, when we were getting a little bit of paying off everything and things were doing good, Tom's like, I'm starting a burger joint called the Rape Room. I'm like, that's a bad idea. He's like, it's hand-cut fries!
There's an acronym.
Best meat in the buns.
Rare.
Always premium.
Terrible.
I know, I got nothing. It's not. It was the wrong road to drive down. It's just the wrong road to drive down. Sometimes you drive down the road. Yeah, especially with rape. Let's get out of here.
We
got to do the prop bet.
Yeah.
Oh.
So it's
let's do that.
I got to grab a claw for this. I'm so excited.
Well, it's Super Bowl weekend.
I don't have any sports music. Let me dial some up.
So I decide. Now, we haven't really figured out what's going to be the bet yet. And I'll have to talk to Samantha about this because we threw out some different things throughout the week, but all bad ideas.
Oh, my God. I just found the official Super Bowl playlist of the Tampa Bay Buccaneers.
I'm still leaning towards Silhouette Challenge for
the
you.
The first song is In the Air Tonight by Phil Collins.
So, so
nerds. Brady must have made weird. This.
Daniel, can you bring up a Silhouette Challenge now?
You can bring up anybody's. It doesn't have to be Tiffany Haddish.
Should we just make it that's
both
the bet?
Of us?
That if whoever loses has to do the Silhouette Challenge?
For me, it's going to be better than the titty Photoshop you wanted to do.
I said it was a mistake.
You didn't say it in front of her. You said it in front of me.
Okay.
I guess those are the only two options.
He freaked the fuck out after last week's show. He's like, you know that whole titty thing I did? Oh, my
God. Jesus.
That was some bad titty improv. And I'm like, yeah, you really
my dying husband
you
hasn't
really
even heard that.
Come on.
The pooch on that one. Travis is at home fighting for his life, and you're going, I'm going to Photoshop your titties.
No, I didn't say it until I found out he was okay.
He was thinking about it, though. He was holding on to it.
He's okay. Oh, okay, God. So what is Silhouette Challenge?
Hold on, I'm trying to find it.
So, Samantha, what
I got Cardi B's Silhouette Challenge. You want to watch that? Yeah, all right, yeah. Here's Cardi B's.
Well, she's a professional.
Silhouette
I mean.
Challenge from TMZ.
Okay.
Here
we go. All right, so you...
Put your
it has to be the show or the song. Oh.
Yeah, and then it changes into this next song.
This is the dumbest shit I've ever seen.
God, I need Tom to do it so bad. I have to win this prop.
You have to strip?
At the beginning, you have the slow version of the song and you're fully dressed. And then during the silhouette, you're scantily clad. And then you dance sexily.
Oh, okay.
Sexily. Right. Sexily.
And there's a
baby. I want you to take off all your clothes and dance sexily on top of
ladies, man.
Baby.
And there's a specified amount of time. It's like 2 minutes. It's like the Harlem Shake or something.
I don't think there's a.
It's
you're,
the TikTok
you're overthinking
thing.
It. Just do that, Willie. My hand on your shoulder. Just do that. If you get that far, I'll be surprised.
Honestly,
this is a bet. I'm serious about that.
2 minutes.
Yes, I am. This is gonna be the only thing in my life.
Are you
serious
gonna be,
about?
Are you and
gambling.
Your wife gonna be fully nude? And are you going to be like...
It can just be Tom. It doesn't have to be his wife. I don't want to involve her in the shenanigans.
Oh,
it's not fair to
Tommy
her.
Or Max.
No, don't you
do
dare.
This. I don't know how to even make that effect, though. It's going to be a...
Just turn the lights on.
I'll have to figure that out. But okay, so we'll set it up. Loser does the Silhouette Challenge.
Okay.
And then we'll debut it on next Friday's show. All right.
Wow. Okay.
God, we're like a real radio show.
Now, instead,
my God, next thing you know, you're going to give a keyword people call for $1,000.
And now, instead of just picking a side, Bucks or Chiefs, and going that route, which I'd be nervous to do.
Who would actually win? Do you feel like an actual Native American? The indigenous folk of our fine
like a chief
United
against
States.
A pirate?
Yeah, I feel like that's a pretty even match, right? They're very similar in that pirate is just white.
Does a pirate
chief?
Yeah. But does a pirate get a gun?
Not all pirates are white.
No, they're absolutely not. But in my vision, the Indians are like brown.
I feel like the chiefs are in better. Shape like
pirates are fat and drunk, fuck a lot of little boys.
They're fat, drunk, pedophiles.
A lot of little boys,
but they do have a blunderbuss,
and they got a peg leg, right?
A patch, a bird. Right.
But blunderbuss then maybe evens it out. The chief is riding fast, stallion, and has got a bow and arrow. I don't know, be close.
Spear.
That's just like the Super Bowl. That's too close to call. In fact, I do not have a side that I like on this Super Bowl. I have no idea. I've heard both sides. And both arguments for each team to win are pretty damn good.
Yeah.
And so
it's gonna be a really good game. Hopefully.
But that makes me think. I was just telling Daniel it's gonna be a blowout one way or the other. Like everybody's expecting a great game, and then some fucking thing's gonna happen.
Last year's Super Bowl 3-7.
Yeah,
or something.
Is there a 38-7?
Let me ask you a weird, almost like a morality question about prop bets that I thought about last night.
Yeah,
are there weird kind of like negative fucked up prop bets for injuries?
Yes.
Injuries?
I mean, you can find them on the interwebs.
Yeah, but not...
Because I almost feel like that's in poor taste, right? It's like the...
Sure it is.
In the big books. Now, here's what they'll do, that you could bet on injuries, but in a roundabout way where...
Instead
you,
of, like, specifically.
So, you could bet that, like, Patrick Mahomes' backup?
Hinny.
Oh, Hinny.
Yeah, yeah, old Chad Hinny from the Dolphins. I was like, oh, no, Hinny's in. I lost my ass. But so you could bet if Chad Hinny will make an appearance.
Okay.
And then that basically is betting that Patrick Mahomes is going to get hurt, right? So same thing. I don't, who even knows who the damn Bucks backup quarterback is? I don't. No one knows.
You're right. I have no idea.
Yeah, yeah.
And they're my team.
Get old fucking wait a minute, old man Leftwich out there. With his, yeah. Anyway.
Well, with the way he runs things, he'd probably be all right.
So this particular...
He was a Jacksonville man.
How this wager is going to go is I asked Samantha to pick five prop bets, right?
And Blaine Gabbert. Gabbert?
Oh, Blaine Gabbert. Yeah.
Gabbert.
The old Blaine Gabbert.
Jacksonville QB. A stinky old Gabbert. if he's in, bet heavy against you.
It'd be
Tampa.
bad if he were in.
So anyway,
that'll never happen. By the way,
that will mean Brady will never play again. By the way, I asked Samantha to pick five prop bets. I picked five prop bets, and how we're going to determine the winner is. I didn't tell you this, Samantha.
Oh, great!
But it was right before. You have to specify. We're going to have $100. $100. Now, you could just be like $20 to each bet, and that would be your $100, and you could just space it out evenly, or...
You're going to have to put the bets in for me.
Okay. Yeah, yeah. And then you'll we'll find the odds and stuff, and then basically, she's going to bet $100 on her prop bets, I'm going to bet, and then whoever makes the most money at the end wins. That's it.
And the loser has to do...
Silhouette challenge.
So, who wants to go first? Samantha?
I say you go first.
All right.
Because this is your whole shindig.
Okay, my first bet is shortest touchdown under 1.5 yards.
Okay.
And that is right now at the odds of -220. You bet $25 to win $11.36. The rationale behind this bet is usually there's a pass interference call in the end zone, mm-hmm. and they place the ball on the one.
On the line, yeah.
Or, you know, you get close, you run, and then...
And then Brady runs that in, right?
Yeah, yeah. Then,
and,
yeah,
then he's like, and then he starts nerd dancing, and then like the hype...
High-five the official. Yeah, yeah,
yeah. Now, the juice is a little high in this bet because so many years this has actually paid out, so now it's -220 for under 1.5 yards, but that's my bet, and I'm putting $25 to win $11.36.
All right,
and that
I didn't do all the math with the.
That's fine.
The
I will do that.
Bet. He just did that to make you look bad.
I am. My first prop bet is about the Puppy Bowl.
Ooh, okay.
So it's going to be the Puppy Bowl winner this year. It's Team Fluff versus Team Ruff. And I'm going with last year's winner. I think he's going to take it this year again. I'm going Team Fluff.
All right. Team Fluff.
Fluff over Ruff.
What's the odds in that? Is it -110?
Again, I couldn't find the exact article.
I believe they do have it, though.
It's probably...
They do. Everything I looked at did have the odds. Yeah. So
it's probably a -110. And if you're just going to do even, 20 on every single
bet. Most people agree with that. Yeah, in the Twitch chat room. We got a lot.
He's a winner.
A lot of fluffers in there.
Okay, Team Fluff. Although now I feel like you're just betting coin flips, so you're obviously going to win.
No, not true.
All right.
Okay.
Because that would be a brilliant fucking strategy.
But also,
you're betting all these coin flips, and then obviously you're going to hit 50% of them. And then I'm betting super goddamn complicated shit.
Yeah,
15 hours of goddamn gambling podcast.
You made no rules.
Yeah, it's almost as if she underthought it, right? And that's better?
No.
What's your next one, Tom?
I just knew Tom was going to pick confusing-ass shit that he doesn't know how to bet on.
This next confusing-ass shit is... first team to 9 points, Tampa Bay Buccaneers, +400.
Okay.
Here's my rationale behind that is, you know how every team now defers when they win the coin toss?
Yes.
To give the other team. Bruce Arians, I heard this on some gambling podcast, apparently the last couple games of the season, regular season, would actually choose to accept the kickoff if he won the coin toss.
And so they can score first?
I guess so. It was weird because now the
There's a weird percentage about scoring first. They say it in Madden all the time. They talk about how it's almost like it
But the NFL standard, coaching-wise, has been to defer. If you win the coin toss, you defer. And, of course,
you want them to go four and out and then score first, right?
So the logic being, and also Tampa's won every coin toss, or sorry, lost every coin toss in the playoffs. So they have gotten the ball first the past, like, six games or whatever. So maybe that lends Bruce Arian to decide to take the kickoff. And now if the Chiefs win the coin toss, they're going to defer. So there's a bigger percent chance that Tampa gets the ball first,
okay,
therefore scoring first. Then even if Kansas City scores,
even it up,
then they score
field
like,
goal.
First team to 9 points plus 400.
Oh, do they have to? They don't have to hit nine.
No. Okay. They just have to go hit nine or above. Gotcha. So I'm guessing the Tampa Bay hits 10 points before Kansas City.
That's an
plus 400. I'm putting $28 on that to win 80. That's my second
one. All right, Samantha.
All right. Maybe I did do another 50-50 for my second ballot. So this one is, will there be a flea flicker attempt in the game? Yes or no? I'm putting 20 down on yes.
No,
doesn't have to be specific on which team, but I think someone's going to attempt it. So I'm putting yes for the flea flicker.
Both teams are known for trickery.
That's correct.
A very square bet, very public. Some would call it naive.
I would call it naive if I knew what naive meant.
To look at the odds. Well, going along that bet, my third bet is how many players will have a pass attempt. I'm going under 2.5. The odds are minus 145 on that. Bet 20, win 13. So my theory being that why the hell would you ever let anybody throw a pass besides Brady or Mahomes?
But there are some guys.
They've done it with Kelsey and the playoffs, actually.
Yeah,
but
there are some guys.
I won this bet last year because I bet no other player would. And I almost lost it when I think it was the Rams. Like, they went back and he had the option to throw or run. And he went to go. I was like, no! But he ran it. Anyway, so I'm guessing that no other player will have a pass attempt in the Super Bowl.
Really? Okay.
If another player actually has a pass attempt, I lose this, obviously.
But all right. Sorry. Yeah. I actually like that one because as soon as it's like one of those ones where all you have to do, it doesn't depend on what the play or if the play is even good or bad.
It only depends
on if they execute the play, right?
I mean, and it's also like trick plays or like fake punts. You know, sometimes a punter will throw a pass, but usually in the Super Bowl, I expect them to play more conservative and not do a lot of that.
Okay. I'm gonna need all of your bets in writing as well.
Are you guys gonna sign?
Because I want to keep track of it as I'm watching. I know he will.
I have the yarn to the numbers, the whole thing. You'll see.
My next prop bet, pretty generic one that a lot of people do. What color will the Gatorade be? Right.
You love this one. This is one of your favorites.
So the options are orange, red. Then there's lime green and yellow as one option, so all of those count as one. Then there's clear / water, which is one option.
Wait a minute. Mm-hmm. They put three colors in one choice?
Lime, green, and yellow are all considered one choice.
Oh, gotcha. Yeah.
There's been a lot of fights and arguments over this in the past.
So they have to include.
Because they're very similar in color. And then clear and water is one option. And there's blue and there's purple. I'm going red because I am rooting for the Bucks. Either way, though, both teams have red in their.
The Bucks do look like a fruit punch team.
So I'm thinking, let's go red.
They look like a fruit punch team.
All right, that's usually. I think all odds are the same.
I think last year was orange, if I remember correctly.
Okay. I remember there was a big fight one year that the Gatorade got diluted so much it came out clear, and then everybody,
it was like Arctic blue, but because there's so much
because there's so much ice, it came out clear. Then
or cloudy.
It caused this huge fight with all the books.
One that's called like cool ice.
People were claiming that it was really purple. It was purple that
but
got
somebody
diluted.
Knows what they put in there.
They had
nobody knows.
They had to but then it's like, how do you get the exact? Do you get the water boy that mixes the Gatorade and be like, I put purple. You know, you're gonna get paid off by someone anyway. Yeah. All right, the Gatorade.
You got one more, right?
Yeah.
Two more.
Two more.
My next bet is. So first down, this goes kind of with the Bucks will get the ball first, and this is kind of what I'm betting on. I'm going first touchdown score, Leonard Fournette, plus 900.
I like that.
So this is, Fournette's been playing well throughout the playoffs. I feel like if they get in within, you know, 5 yard line, Fournette will just punch it in. Mm-hmm. And it goes along the same lines as if Tampa gets the ball first. They march down the field. Leonard Fournette, plus 900. So there's that bet. What do you got, Sam?
All right, so my last two are going to be about the Super Bowl commercials. All right? Okay.
You went stepped out of the bun.
I did.
Think
step
outside
out of
the
bun. So this one is, what will be the first character to appear in a DoorDash commercial? And I got a lot of options here. Grover, Cookie Monster, Kermit the Frog, Big Bird, Elmo, Oscar the Grouch, Ernie, Bert, Rosita, Count Von Count, Abby Cadabby, or Mr. Snuffleupagus.
Not Abby Cadabby.
I have chosen Oscar the Grouch, and I think they're going to make it like, oh, even if you live in a trash can, we'll deliver to you, DoorDash.
Oh, okay, that's smart. I didn't even think about that. Where is that at, actually? I'll bet on that one.
Paper, she was like, she had a lot of confidence.
That's a drop the mic situation.
Yeah, you had a lot of confidence. You're whipping your legal pad in the air.
Oh, I got two other people say Oscar as well.
I can see that, although I was going to go with Big Bird. And on a
but
side note...
But you never
note,
see where he lives, right?
And on a side note, Big Bird, Sam and I figured out, we learned via the Facebooks that in other countries, Big Bird is different colors.
Yeah, that's correct.
Really?
Yeah.
What color?
Like in Hungary, he's red. In Mexico, he's
country,
like three different colors. In Mexico, he's like yellow, red, green.
Yeah.
In like Belgium, I want to say like he's blue. In like Iceland,
that's
he's
just how
like
naive
a,
we are as Americans. We think that Big Bird's yellow everywhere.
Be yellow, goddamn!
No.
I know.
Keep him yellow.
Hashtag keep him yellow.
Keep him yellow.
Butler, print the shirts.
Don't print that.
Tom Van, what's it like being the actual and only Big Bird Proud Boy? You're like, we gotta keep him yellow, man.
I'm going with Cookie Monster.
Yeah, West
my second choice was Cookie Monster, but I'm going Oscar.
Okay,
I'm going Oscar.
That's a good. That's well thought out.
My last bet is Sammy Watkins over 35.5 yards. Now the rationale being that I believe Tampa's going to really cover Kelsey and Tyreek Hill.
Why wouldn't you?
Yeah. And then
but
leading,
Watkins is no slouch.
No, but he was. That's why
he was a beast. Who was he with? Buffalo.
He just can't stay healthy.
No.
So, but he's playing in this game, and I have him over 35.5 yards.
It's funny, Eric Chubb. He says exactly what you're saying. Watkins will be hurt by the end of the first.
Yeah.
I know.
But after,
but he's a talented guy.
After a 36 yard catch.
Yeah. Hopefully. Yeah.
All right. That's my fifth.
All right.
My fifth and
you
final.
You went with boring ass bets.
I went fun route.
I'm team titties all day long.
Yeah.
17 to 20 hours.
I can't wait. I can't wait to see a stiff
miserable
silhouette.
Oh.
So my fifth and final prop bet is not only a 50-50 choice, it's also a commercial choice. It is, will an M&M spokes candy be wearing a mask in a commercial?
Oh, my God.
Yes or no?
Keep them yellow.
Although...
Hey, M&M's.
Yeah, you're right.
Yeah,
peanut M&M.
Yeah.
Although M&M... is usually known in their commercials to be very up to date and very hip with what's going on. I think that they will avoid wearing the mask because people
polarizing
don't want to think about
polarizing
that when they're
too
watching the Super Bowl. I say no, they will not be wearing
all
a mask.
All right,
I
like no that mask. We'll have to look up the odds to make sure, because if it's, you know.
Sam's like, these are well thought out belts from both sides.
Yeah,
like, both of you guys did a nice job on that.
The
okay,
I like Sam's odds.
The amount of props.
<You do. laughs>
Yeah, just go look at some of the ridiculous shit.
There's crazy.
There's one is like, will the weekend mention Trump? Like, it's like,
well,
what?
There was one that, will he mention Canada because he's from Canada?
Yeah, yeah.
And I'm like, probably not. How many wardrobe changes? Probably none for the weekend.
I lost my ass on wardrobe changes last year.
Well, that's different. The ladies tend to change wardrobe. The guys typically don't.
I wonder what the over-under
which, if I was smart,
are.
I probably would have just done that.
You know,
I said
eight,
no.
How many songs do you think will play? I think the number is 8, and Samantha
ooh,
could look up some
that's
of
a lot for half an hour.
He just put out a best of CD.
Yeah, but they
on the cusp.
Yeah, they do snippets.
It's funny, too, because he's a relatively new artist that has a best of CD, which I think is a little weird. But anyway, you know, he put out his best of CD in, like, before he's obviously doing this.
It's
brilliant because you'll sell it. Mm. But I gotta say, I do not like The Weeknd's tiny mustache. This whole trend of tiny mustaches.
Yeah.
I know that Antonio Brown has one now.
Yeah.
And I know he's always rocked the mustache, and then when he went the bleach mustache thing, he was like, you're an insane person.
Trying to get kicked off the Steelers.
We just need to get rid of the
I like that when he had his big lock.
I did too. I thought that looked cool.
Yeah.
I like that better than the tiny mustache and like the suits. I liked him when he looked a little grungier.
Speaking of The Weeknd, we never talked about this, but Daniel brought it up. He actually paid his own money to make the production.
$7 million.
Jesus. So
So that's this is something I've never heard of before, and
because that's the NFL's dime.
It's brilliant in his part because he realized how much publicity this actually is for him and his brand and everything. And so he put $7 million into making the show better, therefore making his brand better, because I'm sure he did the math, his management.
He's not only making it better, but he's making it better for the at-home audience.
Yes, and then so
I think that's where he's putting all of his money is just in the television side, not the stadium side.
Yeah. Of course.
That's a spectacle as itself. Yeah. You know, when you're
there. Yeah. And he's saying, fuck that. I'm going straight for the cameras.
And then he realizes that there must be double the, and then, you know, I don't know what they figured it out as, but they're like, all right, I'm getting $50 million worth of value out of this publicity, so I'll spend $7 million to make it look better. And it's brilliant, and I've never heard of it before. Like, you know, you're performing at the Super Bowl, and you're like, well, you don't have the best, so I'm going to pay to get the best production-wise, because it benefits me more than even you, so I'm going to do that.
He doesn't want an OLA experience.
Yeah. It's OLE, Butler.
I like that. I knew Tom wasn't going to let that go. He stumbles all the time and bumbles. He heard him say one thing wrong, and he's like, I'm good.
Oh, because it was a shot, and he knows that bothers me. Oh, God damn it. anyway.
Forward me your bets so I can keep track as I'm watching on Sunday.
And we're not doing a Twitch broadcast.
That's right.
Okay. Yeah. It's too many people are going to watch this, and we all decided we wanted to be with our families.
I never decided that. For the record,
I actually do want to pay attention to this one.
I'm going
to
be here.
I want to watch it
on the broadcast
by yourself.
By myself. Okay. Oh, it's going to be sad.
I'll zoom in with you.
Me and May. Yeah, we'll do it.
She'll love the halftime show. She'll be great for that.
She's into The Weeknd, but yeah, it's going to be fun. Is there anything else? Are we at the end of the show?
Oh, yeah. It went long.
End of the motherfucking show.
I enjoyed it. anything else to plug before we...
New Semantics this week.
Yeah.
Just recorded it last night with my husband. We'll be releasing it on Semantics Sunday. Also, we are celebrating Semantics' four-year anniversary at the end of the month. So February 28th. It's another Semantics Sunday, February 28th at Rock Pit Brewing.
Cool.
In South Downtown Orlando.
There you go.
Awesome. And check out our watering holes. Gringos has all the magnets and koozies. Go by and put it up on social media, and that helps us out. Mm-hmm. I think that's it. Look at the hookups page. There's a bunch of businesses there.
Yeah. Hats, if you want one, get them now. They're going to sell out, guaranteed. We appreciate all of you guys. Thanks so much for listening. If you're not a BDM, sign up. Anything else?
Nope. Bye-bye.
Wait a minute, I can't publish that. It's, mediocre.
And now it's time for the Tom and Dan end of the show footnotes. Today you heard music from
The Lucas State. This is a fun little jam. I mean, this is basically great Saturday morning driving music from their brand new Fall In, Fall Out album. You heard the song Insert Girl's Name Here. Step on it, homie. After that, we got lucky and lucked out with some very, very fresh and crispy brand new Death From Above 1979 to play for you nutcases from their brand new Is For Lovers album. You heard the song 1 Plus 1. Again, I'm basically giving you everything you need to drive fast on a Saturday. We played Antagonizers ATL on the show before, but they just have this nice kind of tried and true punk aesthetic that comforting to my ears, so you're gonna hear a little more. You heard their song Marching On from their brand new Kings album. We closed out the day with a smattering of electro goodness from the High Plains Drifters. Well, this is like something that I feel like my friend Eric Dennison would have played on Sunday Night Vinyl, except it's brand new. Sunday Night Vinyl on old Real Radio 104.1. And on that nostalgic note, we'll see you next week. Since you've been gone.